Skill level, my drafting I think is okay. I'm still kind of stuck in the super high two drop. Like, I'm overvaluing twos, I think. And while I was tracking, I was able to get between 4 to 5.5 between the classes, 4 being the worst class, which is rogue for me.
Oh, wow. That's very good, then, that we're having a rogue for the coaching session. All right, excellent. So I'll put you on the screen. That's a nice arena deck there on the side, like that. Pretty good drafting. All right, let's open up and see what we got here. So because you're doing the coaching session on stream, you always have the VOD to go back to. So, I mean, you're very free to take notes, but it's also fine if you just rewatch this afterwards for maximum value. Okay. I'll be highlighting this so it's easier to find, and I'll upload it to YouTube. So you can find it either there or in the highlights. So the way I would like to do the coaching session is different from the co-ops. With the co-ops, I mainly take the lead and, you know, do most of the groundwork. In coaching, I like to let you make every single move, or at least start to make the move. If we're going into the rope, I'll just tell you what to do, and then we'll explain after that turn why we did and why we did it. For the drafting as well, you just tell me every time which card you want, and I'll only tell you what I want after you've told me. You don't need to go over like, oh, you know, so this card we don't pick, that card we don't pick. Just tell me what you like, and then if I think anything is off, I'll ask you for your reasoning why you went with that particular card.
Okay.
Alrighty. Okay.
Yep.
Let's get started then, man.
All right. Well, here I'm looking at probably pint size. You know, we don't have any pirates. It's the first card in a draft, and then patrons overcosted for what it is.
Yeah, I think the pint size, while not being that great, is still a fine minion. Yep. Pretty good for a more tempo-oriented deck.
All right. Well, I'm immediately drawn to the Kraken.
Yep, I would say so. It's an extremely powerful arena card. I don't think it has many equals in the neutral department, so pretty nice. It's a win condition, something the previous deck lacked, so it's quite nice.
Silent Knight for stealth and shield.
So here, I think there is a pretty significant quality difference between the Knight and the Raider. I think Raider is just... I don't say strictly better, because obviously the Knight has, you know, the Mind Shield and stealth and stuff. But in Rogue, it's not uncommon to have a 2-damage dagger. So then you're playing a 4-3 for 2 mana. If you just dagger up, it's a 2-mana 3-3. Even if you play without a dagger, it's a 2-mana 2-3. So very flexible. You can squeeze it in here or there. Sometimes she's going to be very big if you have like a buffed Assassin's Blade and such. So for me, it's quite an easy Blood Cell Raider here.
Backstab?
Yep, we like Backstab. Something, once again, the previous deck lacked, so very nice. Nice little reactive card.
I like Sap and Crusher, but I'd probably take Sap as I don't know if we're going to get another one.
Yeah, I'd pick the Sap for sure. It's just such a unique card. 2-mana, delete anything. Don't even trigger death rattles. Whereas, yeah, they can play it again, but usually you'll have won so much terrain on the board that it kind of doesn't matter that you lost the value.
Yeah.
For the people in the chat, guys, I won't be interacting with the chat when we're drafting. I'll be, we can talk about the picks and stuff for a minute or two after the draft. Yeah, you can pick this up, by the way. You can move on. And then I'll continue with the coaching session.
So Psychotron and Zoo, we don't have anything for Zoo, so I'm gonna go with Psychotron.
Yeah, you also want to have some taunts in Rogue especially, or, you know, a form of healing if you're playing a little bit slower. So yeah, pretty happy with taunts.
The card they're removing?
Yeah. And for a pretty decent reason. This card is nuts. It's like really too good. So I would understand. I understand completely they're removing it. But yeah, we'll exploit it while we can. Yep. Valiant, super strong.
So we don't have any fours, but we're still super early in. So I kind of lean toward the Shredder.
Yeah, for sure. Shredder's awesome.
Raider's nice as a big guy when you can dagger on, but I mean, really, you're going to play him on seven. You're not going to play him on five.
Yeah, it's a 7 drop. And it's a pretty good one, but Shredder is a better 4 drop than Valdir is a 7 drop, so.
So I like Toad as a two. I know you talked about needing taunts as a rogue, so I'm also considering Lord of the Arena, but I'm not considering Pit Snake as it's too easily removed.
I don't mind Pit Snake. Here I'll pick the Toad, but I think the Lord is the last pick for me. Especially now with Portal being pushed, playing a 5 health minion on turn 6 is just really, really scary against mages. Whereas it used to be an okay card because it's with Survive Flamestrike, but now you're really pushing up the health. You really want to have 6 health minions against mage.
Okay. So I like Sun Fury for taunt on demand or taunt for two mana and a small body. Tech is obviously better if we're behind.
I think in the kind of rogue deck I'm trying to build, the tech is probably better. So I pick the mind control tech here. It's a
Okay.
pretty infuriating card when it goes off. It's just, you know, I don't feel as comfortable anymore on rogue being the aggressor. Just feels like you run into a wall and you don't kill them.
I don't think it's the Poison Blade.
No, definitely not.
Let's see. What do we have for Battle Cry? We have Kraken and Raider for crowd favorite.
MCT would be a battle cry as well.
Oh, yep, and MCT. So yeah, so I'd go with crowd
Yeah,
over
I think the
recruiter.
favorite's okay. The recruiter would be kind of okay as well, but crowd favorites can run out of control.
And it gives them a target. Like if we have something better, they're gonna they're or if we have something less than the crowd favorite, they're gonna leave us with something on the board to remove the crowd favorite. I'm not a fan of Fork at all. I could be wrong, but it's probably Ship's Cannon.
I think in this particular pack, with the amount of 2 drops we have, I'm okay with the fork. It's a card that I initially didn't like either, but it also depends what kind of archetype you're going for. And I think the slower archetype that we want, the more reactive archetype, actually wants the fork. So I think that's fine. It's not a
Okay.
premium card by any means, but none of these are.
Well, that's hard. I like Backstab. It's got a lot of utility. Squid Face is also decent if you already have a dagger up. And Bomber is just Bomber. Like I wouldn't know what to go with.
If you would be on your own, which card would you pick? Just
I'd probably take the Squid Face
I think it's
for a
a pretty
four.
easy backstab still. You have 2 4 drops. Like, how many 4 drops are you generally looking for? That you'd pick the
Four or
squid face here.
five.
I think four is definitely plenty, and even if you're looking for 5, you're probably still on track. You're not even halfway there. So I think you're definitely fine picking up a backstab here. It just allows us to go that much heavier, having this nice early game.
Burglar.
Yes, burglar. This card's really fun.
Stranglethorn.
We do have 2 mechs, but yeah, Tiger's too good. Also dodges the portal nicely with stealth.
Removal, Shadow Strike.
Yep, Shadow Strike OP. Looks good. Yeah, just, you know, Okay, damn, that
Well,
happened.
it's not the gang up.
I'd say it's not the gargoyle. I think you can be like, Is it Gengar or Shield? I mean, I guess it could maybe be Gargle. Oh my god.
So Shield Bearer basically eats four face damage or more for us.
Not necessarily just face damage. It you could say put it down to protect another minion.
Yeah, I guess we could use it to keep, say, pint size on the board.
Yeah, I
A
think the
turn
Shield Bearer does the most work out of this pack, so let's
longer.
go with the
Gangup's
Shield
too
Bearer.
slow, but you're also talking about being a more reactive deck, so.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think it's ever really the gang up. I was just thinking these cards are so low value. Could it ever be better to like gang up a Shredder or something and then have a better deck? But I think it's still the Shield Bearer.
Oh, I like Sprint for the card draw on seven. Wolf Rider, yeah. So I'd go with Sprint,
I
personally.
think it's the sprint. 1, 2, 3, 4. I've gotten quite some respect for the cycle cards as well, but I think the sprint is still better. And we're fairly light right now, so we do like the card draw quite a bit.
I don't think it's the, what are we, we're at 18 of 30, so I don't think it's the Berserker. Shadow Pan, I like for the combo for a 6/7 on 5, or on 6, or whatever we combo with Backstab or Shield Bearer or another small. Assassinate's, at least from my experience, has been too slow. But again, you're talking about having us go with a more reactive type deck, so that it might be
Yeah,
Assassinate.
I like the assassinate a lot here. You do have the two backstabs to make sure you're not too slow. Like the deck's looking like it can handle itself in the early game right now, so I think I'd rather have the removal.
So, Cobra or SI? Cobra is great if we can keep it alive. It's kind of, but I like SI7's more reactive, which is where we're trying to go. So I'd take SI.
I think in regardless what archetype you're going for, it's the SI. The card's just nuts, right? It's just it's kind of like the Valiant where you get 2 damage basically for doing nothing. It's just the Valiant gets you 1 free damage. This gets you 2 free damage. So very, very good those cards. One second. Got a subscription. State of Raging Grace. Thanks so much for subbing 7 months in a row, my friend. Appreciate that. Okie dokie, what do we
I
want
go to
here?
poison for due to synergy with the rest of the deck right off the top.
Yeah, I'd like the poison here as well.
So it's never the Grizzly.
No.
We already have one sap, so I kind of lean toward getting a bit heavier on top with the Smith. Plus, we get that nice extra weapon damage on the plus two once we enrage.
It's definitely close here. I'm definitely giving the Smith a lot of thought. Sap's just really strong, so I want to make sure it's worth skipping it for. So we have 2 5s right now. I'm just trying to visualize right now. So when these kind of picks happen, this is real tough picks, right? So you just kind of look, okay, what is my deck doing well? Where does it need help? So early game department, we do have double backstab poison. 1, 2, 3, 4-ish 2 drops, so a little load there, but we'll probably get one more, which makes it fine. So early game's looking top-notch. Things like we can handle ourselves. 3 drops, could use another one, which once again probably we'll get. It's fine. 4 drop, I'll probably use another one or two. Just trying to see how we win, right? No reach either. If you had a little bit more draw, I'd feel much more comfortable picking this up, just to make sure you're not dying. I think I still like the sap. It's one of those picks where it looks kind of bad in the draft, but it comes into the game and you're like, oh God, how could I ever thought about not picking this up, right? It's just one of those things that logically, when you look at it while you're drafting, it's very tempting to not pick it because, like, we've got a lot of removal, kind of on another dude. But then, you just sap something back to back, and you're like, wow, just won the game off the back of that, or just, more reliably having a sap. So I think it's still the sap here. It's very close, but it's
Double sap on Bog Creeper is OP.
yeah, those kind of things for sure.
So I like the burglar over the third backstab.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, we do not want to be, especially with the second sap picked up. We don't want to be running out of steam, so anything that can keep us going, more steam is good.
So we have, I like Shadow Pan.
Yep, for sure. We're getting really rewarded for skipping that Smith, getting another premium 5, getting another early card.
I really don't like the Thespian. I like the Silver Moon for a thing to do on four. We only have two.
Why don't you like Thespian?
Well, I feel we're a little lighter, with the like we have saps and yeah, it's a taunt body, but I don't like skipping four. And I don't think we have enough twos to make two twos on four.
Well, the fact that you have two saps actually makes that quite nice, right? They play their Yeti or their Shredder, you sap it back, play a
Okay.
Thespian.
Yeah.
It's actually quite a nice combination. So I think that the way the curve looks, it actually speaks in favor of the Thespian. So I like him here. And it's just such a nifty minion, such a nice minion.
I think it's always fans. Fan right here.
Think
You get.
if we were drafting a while ago, I would have said no, it's an easy profit, but the way I've been drafting Rogue, it might be the fan, yeah. Sorry, you were explaining, go ahead.
Yeah, well, we were talking about cycling cards. So we have a one damage AoE, and we get a card. So.
Yeah, I think in the style we're trying to make here, I definitely like the fan more. It's really just a really fun archetype. It's just really and good, right? So let's pick up the fan. It feels more constructed than it does arena.
So it's not the tiny fan, as cute as he is. Let's see, Tinkertown. So we have one mech. So I'm leaning more toward the silent type as or Silent Knight as a reactive card.
Yeah, I do like the Silent Knight slightly more. It's a bit slow, but with only two mechs, I don't think a 3-mana 3/3 is better.
No. Okay. Micro Machine.
I
I
think
mean.
so. We do have like two Swashburglers, which is pretty cool with Shadow Step. We have Valiant, we have SI
Oh
Agent.
yeah, it's true. We have SI and Valiant too. It
So
might.
yeah.
That's a good argument for Shadow Step.
So it's not like it's a great card, right? It's just like whenever it's been good for me, it's been when I've had an SI. Can you scroll down, please? See if there's any other things. I guess Kraken, but that's a little bit too far down the line. I'm just trying to figure out whether we want another 2-drop now or not. I think consistency-wise, it is still the micro machine. I think it's fine. I think it gives us that double 2-drop on 4 more often.
I like the creeper.
Yep, creeper's
Although
fine.
Beast is a big guy, but he five health is, as you
Yeah,
said,
we're hoping
too
that we get
low.
like a nice little Sunwalker or something here for our last pick. That'd be great because we are light right now. We're pretty happy with that Kraken and the Sprint pickup.
Well, there you go.
Hey.
Well, we don't have any buffs for Fiola apart from I'm not gonna backstab my own minion to give it a divine shield. Spell wise, oh, what do we have? We have some decent heavy removal. I mean, we have a Assassinate, Shadow Strike. I mean, it's a free three cost if we take
Sprint.
Medivh. And sprint, yeah.
No,
So I
I
think.
think at this point I just pick an 8-mana 7/7 just because we need some beef, so the fact that it gives us a very nice weapon is good.
And then it's never both.
Nope. I mean, if you have a super high value mage, maybe it's both, but not for this. Oh, that's very handy. All right. Is there any way you can move that deck a little bit around, or is that just there? It's fine if you can't. It's just like there's like a slight Skype icon in the way, but I'll get it. It's okay. Oh. No, it's okay. It's
I
okay.
can't.
Oh, this
All
is
right.
fine. Skype just removed the button itself. No. Take it away again. That's fine.
Well, it looks pretty decent, although I don't think I've ever gone this light on fours and no sixes.
Yeah, it needs. We need it to be heavy. Sorry. We need it to be heavier, but there is a nice little hidden heaviness to deck almost with the two Swashburglars. They're very nice. They seem to be just ones, but half of the time they're gonna give you reasonably sized cards anyways, right? I think in general it's just pretty good. Let's talk about the ship's cannon and three pirates you skipped. What I skip it for, Gengars. If I look at the deck list, I probably know. Fork? Yeah, fork. What was the fork
Yeah,
block?
fork.
Yeah, I stand by that. The deck's already too light. Just an additional 2-mana card would not have been good. I think so far I'm pretty happy with almost all the picks I made. Maybe in the end the Silvermoon would have been better than the Thespian because we kept getting more twos, which is pretty unlikely right now. We got like Micro Machine, the Creeper, pretty close together there as well. But our deck does kind of gear up to deal with threats in that way. It does have those two saps for turn four. It does have enough two drops for the double two. Overall, I'm pretty curious to see. Like, once again, this deck doesn't look like it's gonna do that much, right? But I've been pretty surprised by these weird weird decks where the curve doesn't look that great, but we do have three cycle effects, I believe, plus a sprint. So, pretty interested. What server are you playing on?
US West or Americas,
Just
so.
America's okay. You can add me there. That's Shady Bunny 2343. Are you doing the dragon mission today? The dragon mission is already over, Clever Grill. It's a highlight. I'll upload it to YouTube gradually. I got it, by the way. I'll do the Druid Beast mission today. Okie dokie, if you're good to go, same here.
Yep. Spin to win.
So, like I said, the way I would like to do the coaching session is just you tell me what you would like to do, and after the games, if necessary, I feel like I talk a little bit about just to see if I can get deeper towards your reasoning as for doing things, because obviously I can just correct mistakes, but I'd much rather, attack it at the root where I can say like, oh, you're doing this because you're overvaluing this or undervaluing that, and that way you'll be able to kind of course correct moves on your own in the future just using those concepts. So that's pretty cool.
Yep, sounds great. So I think we keep the burglar and toss the other two.
The burglar definitely, the assassinate definitely goes. Silent Knight, yes or no? So this is where I like to have a look at my three drops. We got a fork, we got an MCT, we got a SI, we got a Silent Knight. So on curve, this is actually the best three drop we have. So I think that's a decent reasoning for keeping it. We've got tons of twos, and even if you don't land a two, you'll dagger. So it's really not that fun, really not that much of a problem.
Okay.
So just the one and the three for me. So that's sort of your first one. Like, if you're mulliganing, try to really look at your deck and see exactly where its weak points and its strong points are. Don't just mulligan on autopilot and be like, all right, don't keep threes when you don't have coin or whatever.
Okay. Well, there we go.
There we go, indeed.
So burglar.
Yep, burglar away. That's pretty decent. Sharpen the axes. I hope so.
All right, so I'd rather the poison almost makes me want a dagger to take whatever, whatever. If he coins out a three drop, I mean we can instantly remove it with if we dagger this turn and poison next.
By that logic, you can still dagger poison next turn.
That's true.
I'm not
So.
saying that means we don't play it. I'm just saying that the logic is off. So the reason why I would dagger here is that it dodges several things, such as coin SI, Buccaneer coin dagger. So Rogue v Rogue is all about not opening an easy target for your opponent. Play slow, make sure he really needs to work to get value out of his early damage. So I just dagger up and use the 1/1 in the face and pass. With the reasoning, not so much because then we can deal with a four health minion, but more with the reasoning of I don't give my opponent a target. So he's gonna mirror us, just take it slow. So that's kind of what Rogue v Rogue is all about. Just dance around his removal.
One of the silent
Yeah, perfect, right? Follows suit. Just another stealth thing he can't target. So here is where we kind of force him to make a move, right? We're like, all right, you can't interact with our board, you need to play something, and then we get to react.
So poison clear.
Poison clear, definitely. And then we can talk about what our next move is. You'll always take five, there's no way around that. So this is pretty much a success, right? We forced him to make his first move, and now we kind of react to that.
So we toad on the left.
It's either the toad or the tech, right?
Yeah, I think we get more from the tech though as the later the game goes on, unless we're just constantly clearing.
So you definitely want to think about that. You also want to think about mana efficiency into your next turn. So by playing the mind control tech this turn, you open up, say, Fan plus Toad next turn. And just in
Okay, yep.
general, there's more options. So I play the mind control tech because of that. I do realize that we are using a battle cry rather, because we have crowd favorite, but I think it's still better to drop the tech.
Okay, tech on the left.
Yeah. In general, if there's no enough things on the board, you just want to put the highest health minion on the left.
Okay.
So his coin is burnt, that's good. He just has to react to what we do. That seems really. Oh, I think he misread it for Battle Cry and Death Rattle. This might be a newer player. That does feel like a
So,
thing he would do, right?
yeah.
Oh, or maybe he thinks he'll spawn a weapon, that's why you preemptively hit. I don't know. It feels like that, right?
So we go with the two twos and clear the 4/4, or do we drop the.
I'm thinking if
I
it's
like.
ever fan to keep our dude alive.
Yeah, that's. Fan, we deal the one and we cycle, so I think that's
Yeah,
correct.
I actually like the fan here. Yeah, just because he doesn't have a good out, right? Skulker doesn't do it anymore because he stabbed our guy. So I like
Yeah,
the fan
exactly.
start here. Yep. Turn our face into his guy. We push our dude's face. What would you rather play here, the Toad or the Creeper?
I like the creeper, as it's
I like the Toad
stickier.
right now. We're pressuring a lot. So, Toad on the. I guess right is still fine. Yep. That's good. I don't like the 2/1 killing the frog with the betrayal. So, my reasoning here, whereas normally I would totally agree with playing the Creeper, right? You play less into AoE and stuff, but I feel like, especially with this mistake he made, we can capitalize on that and go aggressive.
Okay.
Shady, why are you putting high attack minions on the left? No, low, high health minions go on the left, just in general for Flame Tongue, Dog. I guess in a way, Argus as well. It's just good habits. Also, if you have a Direwolf, right? You could have something, say, like a Cultmaster. You'd put that on the very far left because you don't want your Direwolf buffing up Cultmaster because you don't want to trade with that either.
Okay, so we Shadow Strike to the MCT.
Yes, and then he goes with the dagger here.
Let's see. Crowd favorite dagger?
He so already crowd, burned her. Crowd favorite, definitely. We'll put him on the far left, right? And then we indeed have three options. Pint-sized, Haunted Creeper, or dagger. Okay. You can already push the frog phase. That's happening anyways. So you're... Sorry, go ahead. Explain why dagger.
No, I after hearing it, pint size actually gives him another target that he wants to get rid of, possibly more than the crowd favorite. Might be where I'm...
So my reasoning here would be to put the creeper in the middle, because if we can get pint size down next turn, we can crack it on 8. So I want to make it more likely she lives through turn 7. So now she only has to live through one turn rather than two.
Yeah, yeah.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
All right. These are a little bit more, you know, advanced things where you're thinking ahead and thinking what could potentially happen. And in specific cases, it could be right or wrong. Honestly, you could play things. And turns out to be pretty useful to have the creeper on the board now, so that's also good.
Well, we use the creeper. Well, I think we're still fairly high health, so we could dagger to pop the shield and then trade in with the creeper and the crowd favorite.
Yeah, that's the first half of the play. We'll do that, and then we'll focus on positioning as such.
And then we put the summoner on the far left to
sure.
avoid betrayal.
We'll put her on the far left, yep. And then where does the Thespian go?
In between the 1/1s, right?
Yep, I like it. I face for 3. I think there were 2 acceptable positions there. In the very middle or on the very far left. But considering he has taunt, he can't stab a 1/1 to make the betrayal better, so I like this. The thing is that also, you know, it feels rather late to play a pint size, so I don't think he's giving it much thought. Okay, GG. But I think that, you know, the experienced player may be like, ooh, that means he can crack it next turn, so. Definitely something I keep track of. Turn 9 for me is always Kraken. That's always an option for me because it's such a... Like, when's the last time you skipped the Kraken, right? It's just like something you pick if you see it. And it's such an insanely big swing that if possible, I try to play around it. Yeah, you can just queue up. I don't think there was that much to talk about in that particular game. I think the biggest thing was... the mulligan to make sure that you know your deck list, right? Spend a couple minutes studying it, just know where your mana curve is high and low. We had lots of 2s, plus your hero power is really good, so there was no reason to dig for a 2. I think the other thing was, you know, instead of daggering up on 6, playing the toad from a pressure, or the creeper rather.
I like all the things.
So you do a full keep here?
The only thing, I mean, we have coin, so we can turn 3 Shredder, so I guess we could dump the fan.
Yep, for sure. I think this is a good reasoning. We don't have many 4s, so keeping a 1, 2, 4 with coin is definitely good. Heck, I'd do it without coin. I'd keep 1, 2, 4 here if we didn't have coin.
And we got nice removal anyway, so.
Yeah, not necessarily what we're looking for in this early. Like, we'd rather hit something like a backstep or a poison. But that's fine. Yep, Smash Burglar is okay. Not terrible. This means that we're definitely heavy enough, so we'll have to see what he does. If he's extremely aggressive, it's probably going to be useless to sprint. Previous Rogue went 7 Calderash. We lost twice pretty fast to like really aggressive decks.
So I like... I'm becoming to like Dagger Pass more.
Yep.
Like he still has one charge on his dagger, so we die to backstab for free.
Yeah, once again, we just want to make it more difficult for him to cash in on early value from weapon buffs.
Okay. So we have Coin Shredder for 4. We have Shadow Strike to remove and reset. Or we have this wonderful Shield Bearer that'll take a hit to the face and keep a Blood Sail alive as a 3/3. Coin Shredder dies to Nerubian. So we run into the same early removal thing, right? I mean, if we drop the Shredder, he trades for free, and then, you know, what?
What do you mean trade for free?
Well, he trades the Nerubian in.
That's the best case scenario. The worst case scenario is he poisons up or he backstabs. He kills your Shredder and then free kills your second half. So I'd lean toward Shadow Striking here because I think the risk of the 4/4 free killing your second half from the Shredder is too high.
Okay.
If I could get a guarantee that the 4/4 will trade with the Shredder, I think Coin Shredder here is fine. But I do also like the option here that your coin is preserved. You'd have quite a heavy hand. Drawing the second sprinter as well is pretty nasty.
So we play Shredder. He hits with Panda or removes. We haven't enforced any removal, so Bloodsail Creeper?
I think Shredder still is fine. I think that it's nicely on curve. It gives us more options. Like, our hand is going to be pretty disgustingly bad here with Medivin 2 sprints. I mean, if it ever happens, right? Medivin
yeah.
And sprints, it's going to be great. But I think we just played a Shredder here, and it's slightly, you know, sapping a 3-drop is a beat, but it's only going to become more flexible for him to sap. So I think I'd rather get the Shredder out right now and have the 2-drops later on.
Okay.
That's pretty good for us. He spent 5 mana. Ooh, the backstab. Well, I mean, at least we played around the backstab earlier. That's good. We are getting extremely unlucky right now. He also mispositioned the 2/3 should have been in the middle. Ooh, that could be our ticket back into the game.
So do we vomit low cost cards and just kind of hope he efficiently trades and play something to steal, or?
Yeah, I would play the Shield Bear as well this turn, just to make the trades a little bit better for us. So just play the 1/2/2 and pass.
So play the
the Creeper and the Bloodsail here.
Okay.
Yep. So basically, like you said, right, just put the low-cost minions on the board. Nice. Yep. Thought he would use the 3/3 in his face there.
Yeah, I thought he would 3/3.
He's going to smoke.
Well.
Sure.
So we MCT.
One more mana would have been amazing. Yeah, we have to MCT. Yep. It's too strong. I mean, if we steal the 4-4, we actually maybe have a chance. Still decent.
Nothing to burn coin on, so the question is, what do I stab? Do we stab the Drake to make him worry about us trading into it?
I'm pretty sure it'd be okay to just stab his face and redagger. I don't think we're going to be running out of dagger charges anytime soon.
It feels so wasteful just daggering the face with no, you know.
Yeah, but I mean, if you take four here, I mean, we're in a really bad position regardless. We might need to just coin Medivh here to start get these sprints into seven drops, but opponent's all over us right now.
So seven, we could pompous Shadow Pan. Preserves the coin, but for what? I mean, it really doesn't make sense to save the coin at this point, right? We're far enough in.
Saving
and we don't
coin
have...
indeed would not be a reason to play the 5 and a 2.
So I think coin Medivhs still to play, and then we sprint on the next turn.
Well, the thing is that if you Medivh now, he's just going to run by and you're going to die next turn. So I think you have to Thespian Shadow Pan and face into the 4-1. I think it just gives you a little bit more stopping power. Puts two bodies on the board. Like, it looks cool to do the Medivh sprint thing, but it's just, we're just going to be dead by the time it happens.
And do we clear the dragon,
yeah,
correct?
Definitely clear the Drake. Yep. So if we had stabbed the Drake last turn, it would be resulting in the same scenario. We just have two charges right now. I don't think that matters because Medivh replaces the weapon anyway, and it played a little bit safer. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, I mean, he had way too much stuff. I mean, it was too much. He just went way too ham. And we just got extremely, extremely bad starts.
So we trade. I think we're dead, no matter what.
Well, we're definitely not dead no matter what. You could coin aside a 3-2, 6-7 into the 4-3, and then you'd have 7 damage. I'm not saying that that's the line, right? I'm just thinking there's other things we could maybe do.
I mean, we could sprint and hope for sat. I'm kind of stuck.
Yeah, I think we do sprint and hope to find backstab and sap. That's pretty much my my line here. We have a lot of them in the deck, so.
Nope. Not a one.
All right. That means we are officially dead because we can't remove. All right, so GG. So even though the other line kept you alive, it put you on 1 health and you're just dead the next turn. So you're alive, but not really, right? Because
yeah.
you also have no move for next turn because you've just used your coin and SI. Your hand is Medivh sprint, and you've got nothing. The alternative line would be to play Medivh coin and then hope for a target dummy. But I mean, once again, that's not that good, right?
Yeah.
It's. I think this was just a classic case of extremely poor draw, right? The Swashburglar gave us a sprint out of all things. We drew our sprint. We also drew our Medivh. So this deck is really light, and we drew Medivh sprint, even though we don't even have 2 sprints. So very, very, very heavy hand. And then our opponent just had such a fast start, especially with that Nerubian on 3 and then the Drake with the backstab killing your Shredder in 1 go. So I think it's just a classic case of too fast of a start and not enough reactive stuff for us. The Skulker was also amazing for him. It was just, yeah, it's too good. think the sprint definitely gave us the highest chance for an out there.
Yeah. Pulling four, and we have two backstabs and two saps. Like.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not even sure. I don't think we had used any of them, right?
No, we didn't.
Yeah. Yeah, that's rough. Yeah, I mean, finding sap plus backstab there probably just puts you in the game, right? Because you sap the 4-4, you backstab the barber, you trade the 4-3. Yeah, and suddenly he probably needs to trade. Okay, Hunter, cool.
So I like keeping the Shredder, again, for the same reasons as last time. I mean, we don't have the coin this time to force it out, but it's one of our only two drops.
I agree. I would just ditch the Micro Machine here, keep the Toad and the Shredder.
Yeah, Micro Machine seems kind of slow against the Hunter, who's going to be coming hard for us.
And we just don't want two drops. We want Backstab, we want Poison, we want Swashburglar, maybe MCT.
I mean, look at the curve, though.
Creeper's a decent pickup as well. You could play something here like the Grandma, which means the Creeper's probably better.
Yep.
Such big teeth I have. Now we of course need to see whether that's actually true. So if we creeper here, it's pretty unlikely he trades in. Yeah, I like the creeper here. So like I think we talked about that, right? Where that's the reason we were pretty happy with the creeper in hand.
Yeah, specifically for the grandma.
So the way how I quickly went over that is that technically the Toad isn't that bad, right? Because, you know, he trades in, you have your guy, but on the hunt, really good. Glaivezuka, really good. Arcane Shot, really good. There's a lot of things that snowball the game for him there. Whereas the Creeper's nice and safe. So he's got a 3 drop. Okie dokie.
Like, so we can dagger clear. I think that's still a beast, yeah. So he's gonna have a beast on the board no matter what. MCT dies. So I think we go dagger and remove one of his things.
That's too slow. I think that'll get us killed. I'm pretty sure we're playing Toad. The only thing I just don't know is whether we're popping the Creeper now or not.
Okay.
So you can go ahead and play the Toad.
So if we pop the Creeper... I think we do, because if he trades into the Toad, we have a decent chance to at least that one damage.
I like to pop the Creeper here. Probably the elephant, it's fine. Either way, it's fine. So, is this slightly inefficient? Yes, because the 3-1 now gets to kill the Toad, but he's not hitting our face. So, as a hunter, making it awkward for your opponent, making it awkward to hit the face is obviously a good thing, right, if you're playing against the hunter. So he's putting more stuff on board to minimize the chance the spit is going on to the 3-2, but... Oh, wow. Okay. We accept.
Shredder and trade.
We could just MC tech, right?
Well, we trade, yeah. Okay, so we pop, we MC tech, see what we get, and then trade from there.
Yeah, I think MCT is a little bit too good, so let's go with that.
So the Toad goes in to the wolf.
Yep, good start. See what happens here. Yeah, it's fine, we just bump. He's out of stuff.
Yeah, then we clear his stuff.
Yeah, MCT is just, even though you're only spending 3 mana rather than 4, this card is worth, I don't know, 12 mana or something. If you count it all up, it's ridiculous.
It's like I have a lot of negative bias to the MCT though. It's always... pulls the 1/1, it seems like.
I mean, if you pull a 1/1, that is still an insanely good card. That's the thing that most people don't realize. It's like if you MC deck a 1/1, you've just used like an Elven Archer type effect on his side. You've also summoned a 1/1 on your side, and you've put down a 3/3 body all for 3 mana. So if you compare it to a Razorfen, right? Razorfen's 2/3 and summons a 1/1. Not only do you get a 3/3 instead of a 2/3, you've also got an Elven Archer out of it. It's pretty nuts. So that's the
Tiger clear face.
I don't hate Psychotron in face here, like make it more awkward for him.
Okay.
I think if you just put the Psychotron on the right-hand side, you just go face and just make use of your taunt, right? Sure.
There's the real MVP. We pint size. No, we don't have enough mana. So I think we're daggering.
Why are we daggering?
Take four. Oh, okay. Well, for the face, because I really don't like over trading. Or we
All right, I'll
can.
take you through my play and I'll explain, right? So put the micro machine on the between the 3/3 and the 2/3. Put the SI agent on the very far left, targeting the Misha. Trade the 2/3 into the Misha, use the 3/4 to free kill the 3/1, and then push 3. So this is a common thing that I see in a lot of people that I coach, is that they don't want to be wasteful. They're like, yeah, you know, if you dagger here, it lines up a lot nicer, right? The 3 and the 1 go into there, you free kill the guy. So what is your board if you do that, right? You have a dagger, I don't, and you develop a shredder, right? You develop a shredder over an SI, but what I've done is I've not taken 4 face damage against a hunter, and I've developed two things rather than just the shredder, because in my play the micro machine comes down as well. So it's just more of a fast play in a fast game. Like if we were playing a very slow value game, I could be persuaded into your play, but it's not. It's a pretty high tempo game, this one.
Well, I think the Lerox goes away. So we backstab, trade the MCT, and then Tiger Dagger, and push the rest face.
Here we're actually fine with just Tiger Dagger and don't backstab, right? I feel like the 2 damage we can tank and then the backstab helps us get through the next thing.
Okay.
So where would you put the Tiger?
On the far left.
Dead in the center is good for me here. It's stealth, right? So we can't explosive shot.
Okay, yeah,
If that's the way you're
sorry,
going, yeah.
I forgot
Okay,
hunters
no, it's all
were
good.
a thing.
So dagger up, use the 3/3 in the face. Either 3/3 is fine, and then face with our dudes.
Okay, so we're just
The
going pushing
3/3 in the
things, right?
face, hit his guy. So MCT and dagger, kill the Leoc, right? Alright, send it face, go, 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 go. Alright, so confused there, or what was the, was I not clear enough on the Leoc dying, or?
No, it was my daughter came in. She's playing
Oh, no worries, dude, no
the
worries.
clarinet in the back.
So I don't care at all about the results for me during the coaching session, even though I still track them. So like I just want to make sure that our communication is good when we're playing, right? So even if you do make a mistake here or there, don't really care about it. I just want to make sure that we have a good
He's
experience
dead.
here. Yeah, he's very dead. GG. So this was a very good game, I feel. This was a good game for learning in terms of what may be going wrong when you're playing Rogue on your own. So here I feel like you were about to play really slow in a game where you want to be playing fast. You're playing against a hunter. Hunters are pretty aggressive in general. Life totals are very, very life totals are very, very relevant. So if you have the option to use your SI agent plus developing a micro machine over, you know, Shredder and daggering up, right? In my line, you were also only losing a 2-power minion rather than a 3-power minion. So overall, I developed 5-power plus saved another one. So I guess you have 6-power more. By the time it's your turn, you have 7-power more because it's a micro machine compared to the 4 from your Shredder. So yeah, that's a 3-power gain plus you didn't take 4 phase damage.
Yeah,
that's quite relevant. So just try to look at it, and yeah, you can queue up, by the way. Just try to don't be too careful with your resources. That's a common thing I see, where people are a little bit too careful with their resources. Like, obviously, when you're learning the game, you get taught, like, hey, don't polymorph, it's 2-drop, that's not a good thing. But sometimes that gets taken a little bit too far, right? Where assigning his guy was perfectly acceptable there.
Again? Mm-hmm. Is this the third rogue today?
I love Rogue v Rogue, so you don't hear me complaining here.
So I'm not a fan of either of the twos. I want to keep Shadow Strike.
What's the reasoning for wanting to Shadow Strike here?
He has a coin, so I don't think we'd end up redrawing Shadow Strike, and I just like to remove his stuff outright on 4.
So if he coins his Yeti, you'd be okay with Shadow Striking it on turn 4, floating a mana?
Yeah, we're he's burning a coin plus his 4 drop.
And he's just going to play another 4 then, though, and then yeah. we don't have another Shadow Strike. I just keep the Toad here. So my explanation for this is that I do like Shadow Strike when I have coin. I don't think up to the point that I'd keep it, but I think if you don't have a coin, Shadow Strike doesn't do that well because of the thing. Yeah, it's back. So, the thing that I just mentioned, like, you're Shadow Striking his guy. Like, it's okay if he just plays a 4 on his 4 and then you're going into your turn 5 and then you 2-drop Shadow Strike, but I don't like it into a coin 4. I don't think that's very good.
So we're daggering.
Yep.
And clearing.
Dagger the thing. It's also about what you're giving up for keeping the Shadow Strike. You're giving up a slot that could potentially be Backstab, Poison, Swash Burglar, a 3-drop, right? You're putting a lot of pressure on your curve by keeping that.
So I like Toad Swash.
Yeah, I think we play the Swash Bird or see what we get, right? Could be an Auto Barber and then it's pretty insane here.
Yeah.
Not quite.
I think we go with the Toad.
Yeah, I'm just thinking if we ever go for the greedy line of Stab His Fork and Redagger. That means we tank probably additional 6.
Yeah.
Not always the 1-1 could go. Yeah, I think that frog will do. Thing is, like, he's getting a lot of value out of this fork. It's trading into a card plus getting a...
He also burned his coin, though, to get it out.
Mm-hmm. Seems unlikely that he wants to play something first. Oh, you're not killing the frog? Wow.
If he doesn't want to kill the frog, that's fine with me.
Yeah, we're pretty happy with that. Got a pretty solid fan coming up here. Yeah, please straight to 1-1. It saves me some health.
So I think we're, well, yeah, we're fanning and floating. I think trade the frog into the creeper and fan.
Eh, not always. Because of this line, we could just play a crowd favorite, stab the fork, and push three.
Yeah, and then, well, yeah, then he has Noah.
Just thinking
about it,
right?
He pops the creeper on his own. Yeah, he pops the creeper on his own, and then we set up.
Then he equips the thing. Yeah, I like that more. I like just crowd favorites face into the fork and push three. I think that was just a mistake on his part. He should have just traded the fork for the frog, then developed the creeper, be in a good position that way. So I think it's pretty likely he goes for the fork here. I think we're facing someone fairly new, and he just goes like, oh, nice. One in the face, kills the 4-4. Doesn't get to grow. We're pretty happy if he doesn't, right? If he just develops and we get to reply. Oh, he's got it. All right. That's weird. Why wouldn't you equip the fork then? Oh, man. Interesting plays.
So, the creeper doesn't do anything if we push frog face. Then what do we do? Sensei Undercity? Sensei's 2-2, Undercity's 3-2. So, we drop the Sensei. I don't like to use the Valiant ping on the face, but I mean, that's, alternatively, we pop the creeper, fan of knives, and re-dagger.
I think it's fair to drop the Sensei dagger up and push three face. I went through a lot of the lines that you're going through right now, and this just ends up better every time. So just Sensei dagger hit him for three. So what this does is it makes it a bit more awkward for the creeper. He could equip the fork and take down the Sensei depending on how much he fears it. But this also has the upside that you're preserving your Valiant. So next turn you have, say, he pops his creeper, this turn you have Fan plus Valiant, or you can go Shadow Strike Fan or whatever you want. I like to be a little bit greedy with the Valiant. So yeah, he does the expected line. Oh, it's going to be quite the fan here. Nice. Unless he doesn't pop. I guess we can pop on our own.
Okay, so Sensei into one creeper, face the 1-1.
And let it fly. Fan. Yep.
And
we'll start with that, right? Whenever there's card draw involved, you do the thing and then reevaluate. It's a good habit to cultivate.
It's still go blood sale.
Yeah, for sure. There's really no reason to play Undercity, right? This is a 3-3 over a 3-2, and Blood Sail Undercity has a better effect.
Cool. Yeah, we'll want to save the ping.
Yep. All good. So this is going much better than the other Rogue game where we lost, where he was super aggressive. We're kind of just, you know, exchanging quite well. He's just going to deal with our guy here. But we have Medivh and Kraken, so if we're going even, that means we're winning.
So we can Shadow Strike ping with Valiant to clear the dragon. Leaves us with two and then creeper.
Yeah, that's definitely the right move for this particular turn. I'm just thinking whether we ever save Shadow Strike for the Medivh. Because you could do something weird with play the creeper, our guy gets buffed, you can backstab, trade, play the Valiant, just floats a bunch of mana. I think we're totally on board with the Shadow Strike. Are we about 2, 3? Yeah, we could technically save it. We just lose the Undertaker.
Yeah, if we trade, we backstab, trade in, face.
All right, let's just Shadow Strike. It's cool. Yeah, Shadow Strike and Valiant. But the creeper is somewhere in the middle. Just push face with our dudes. I think this just puts a little bit too much pressure out. I think it's all totally fine. It hits his face for more. We don't have to use our face. We keep the backstab, which is also pretty flexible. Sure.
Medivh, and then backstab, and
yep, Medivh far left, backstab is dude. Enjoy our target dummy. You can almost argue that you don't want to waste the charge on this.
And then push two face.
I'd always exchange with a creeper. I think there's no reason. Why were you wanting to push face here?
This we have the taunt. I don't think he has another backstab.
But wouldn't you rather have the taunt for whatever he plays next? Like, he's still dead with the Kraken, right? So this just makes it less likely he gets to deal with your Medivh. I'm gonna give you a concrete example, right? What if your opponent goes Skulker, kill the target dummy, kill the 1/1, your Medivh is suddenly at 5, and then he goes like Valiant, trade the other Skulker. That's a not so unthinkable scenario. Or any other like combination of, say, him using fan plus face onto the dummy and then eviscerate trade into your Medivh, or just anything there, right? Just not removing that body and just expecting him not to have anything for the taunt, I think, isn't correct there. Missed one damage? Sure, guys. Sure.
We crack in the Brewmaster, clear the 0/5 with Medivh, and push one.
So I think at this point, MCT might be one of the only ways you lose. So I'd actually put the 7/7 into the 0/5. Actually, we don't have any way. We have the 0. No, that's no way. So do we ever just set up lethal with the Kraken? Need healing then. Yeah, I think you sap the 0/5. Then you just play the pint sized, go face with your dudes. So because he's dead to Kraken right now, and because we had a read that he's going to play more taunts, I think this is probably better. Because there is a way where he might survive if you do it in a different order.
Yeah, same. There's the double. Yeah. Do we go for the sprint BM?
Well, he wouldn't be dead if we do that, right?
Yeah.
All right, nice. I'm quickly going to the bathroom.
I will.
missed sprint BM. Well, he is not dead if we sprint, guys. To be incorrect play.
Thanks to chat for being supportive with my terrible plays.
Well, no, I mean, the fact that you're taking coaching is great. Like, you need to be very, like, you need to put yourself out there, otherwise you won't learn. So that's like, there's a lot of people who will just not do it right. Right, they're just like, eh, I'll just blame RNG. It's a lot easier, but you don't get better off that. So. I'm good to go, by the way. I don't think we have too much to talk to about that particular game. I think once again, the thing here that keeps coming back, and you know, if you're taking notes after, if you're watching the VOD, to remember the mulligan. Mulligan is such a huge part of the game, and keeping the shadow strike there, I think, is always wrong.
Toss the fork. Oh. I want to keep backstab SI, as those are our bread and butter.
You're setting up, I mean, against the rogue. The hand looks really good. I think I just keep here. I think it's really flexible. We have a 2 if we just want to go slow. We have backstab SI. We have coin SI into fork. Like, there's tons of different options we have here. This looks really nice. Okay.
Yeah, the only one I'm... I don't know, I'm probably carrying it. Like, I just don't like the fork overall. So...
We don't have many 3 mana plays, and it's fine. Honestly, it's 3 power. It usually does the same thing as a 3-3, really.
That could be the grand tournament meta that I'm... the last time I was playing this, so...
Yeah, for sure. The game has drastically changed. You need to be okay with playing slow. It's definitely part of the game right now.
So... I think we just pass. I think coin micro is...
Yeah, exactly. We just pass here, right? Like, we're playing a more very reactive deck, and I feel like... Honestly, right now, unless your deck is really streamlined, really aggressive, going reactive is really the way to go.
So we can backstab dagger, we can pompous. If we drop the pompous, we bait out an early frostbolt if he has it. So I think I'd play Pompous.
I think this is a particular case where coin forked as well. Because it does the same role as a Pompous. It's a 3-2, but you get your weapon out of it. He'll likely try to play around the 3 damage from the fork, play a 4 health dude, and then you can backstab SI. And then you have double 2 to play on turn 4. So I like the coin fork in this particular case. So early game is really key in Rogue. So you really want to look through all your cards, look what he's going to do, look what you're going to do, and then see if the numbers adds up. And I think they do if we do it this way. I mean, even if he goes like, so here's a 4 health dude. Like, even if he went for Frostbolt, it's still good because we just equip the fork and kill his dude.
Backstab SI?
Yep. Pretty much what we've been planning, right?
Yep.
And I really like the fork as it has this insurance, as in even if you torch, bolt, or flame cannon my guy, I just equip the fork and kill your raider, so it's not an option.
So we can fork. We can fork clear. We can fork face clear whatever comes out. We can sap micro, or we crowd favorite and he just trades in.
What play are you leaning towards?
Sap micro, I think it starts.
This is what we. This is really what we were planning in the draft, right? picking up that second sap, picking up those two drops so we can do this. Yep, sap macro looks great here. Do you have the chat open, by the way, or not?
No, I just have the one screen, so I...
Okay. Just saying, because it's better if you're reading the chat afterwards when you're catching up, if you just have the VOD.
Yep. So, fork. Fork Pompous, clear the Belcher.
Clear the Belcher how?
With the micro.
Yep,
and
I agree.
Trade the 3-3 into the taunt after.
Yep, that's good. Belcher, really good minion against what we're doing here.
Yeah, especially because I've noticed mages like to stall as much as they can, because once they start hitting the higher tier.
That's pretty good frame here. Did you just ping the non-town? I think you did.
Yep.
For people in the chat saying that the sap wasn't correct on 4, you're wrong. Talk about it later. So, what are we doing?
I think we use the fork to clear the 2-2, drop the crowd favorite, and re-dagger.
Yep, that sounds good here. You gain way too much tempo with sapping there, guys. You also don't know what pops out of the shredder. You also don't know if the mage is going to opt to remove or to develop on turn 5. There's so many variables there. We just hit one of the very particular scenarios where sap was slightly better if we could go into his turn 5. And I say slightly because sapping the shredder is still more stats than sapping the Belcher. So.
And we still have, like, what? We have 20 cards left, so it's...
Yeah. You also have two
saps. A little under 5% to drop another sap, I mean.
Yeah. It's definitely right to sap Shredder on 4 there. Especially because it's mage. If you're playing against the druid, sure, right? You're expecting Druid of the Claw, you're expecting just a good 5 in general. But against mage, using the sap on the Shredder there, 100% correct.
Well, he doesn't have Flame Strike. So we're clearing the 1-1 with dagger no matter what.
No.
No?
It's not no matter what, right? If you would opt to clear the board, you could use a 3-1 into the... Sorry, I thought you said you were killing the 2. Never mind. I think we're sprinting. That's why I say that. I think I'd rather see what I draw first. I don't think it matters. Like, we're not using Shadow Strike, so...
Yeah.
No, I thought you wanted to use your face on the 2-1. No, yeah, you're absolutely right. Face into the 1-1, 100%. And then would you rather trade or would you rather go face?
So he doesn't have a Flame Strike, so he's more than likely going to ping the 3-1. So I'd rather get something out of the 3-1 and take 3 off his face before...
I think we have a dagger equipped, so I think he feels pressure to trade anyway. I'd like to push the 3 face, yeah.
Yep.
Like, if he pings here, he can't play a portal. Not, I mean, portal face isn't that bad, I guess. But in general, it's like, we don't mind this. We don't mind it at all. Shady confusing us? Yeah, sorry, guys. I'm so on autopilot with stabbing a 2-1 that I didn't see. Oh, wow.
Yeah, oh, wow. So we clear the 2-1 with a dagger, or do we Shadow Strike the 5-6?
Those are indeed your two options, right?
I don't think he has a Frostbolt, and he very clearly didn't have a Flame Strike.
So I think for, it's better for me to just lay out, I think, what I feel are the two best options here, right?
Okay.
It's either Shadow Strike, the 5/6, stab it, play the Panda, pretty good tempo, or stab the 2/1 and play Medivh. And I think because of the makeup of our hand, we can survive if we go for the Medivh line. So I think face the 2/1 first and then play Medivh is correct. Because not only does Medivh set up some crazy shit with Assassinate and Shadow Strike, it also just sets up a 7/7 body challenging the 5/6.
Yeah, and he's already shown he doesn't have much in the way of removal in his hand. So he might have
I
top
don't know.
deck
I
something.
don't. Where are you getting the read that he doesn't have removal?
Well, the way I would have done the mage was I would have frostbolted earlier if I had it, just to try to keep
Well,
the
no, I
rogue
mean,
from having
when
any
we're
wound
playing
pressure.
Medivh, I think we're talking removal as in the sense of a sheep or a fireball or something, right?
Yeah. Okay. So I think we assassinate the 5/6. Well, if that, we still have to test. So
I believe you start, and I'm just gonna do this turn because it's quite long and stuff. I believe you start with Shadow Striking the Shredder here.
yeah, effigy. Assassinate the 5/6, push Medivh face, and then Swashbuckler.
I
Barber
like
first.
the shield bear assassinate the 5/6/7 phase. Yeah. It's pretty nuts. Pretty nuts. So normally Shadow Striking a Shredder a little bit less desirable, but with the Medivh on the board. So I'm pretty happy we went for the kind of slow play with the Medivh on curve, but it did set up some wonderful stuff we could do with the Assassinate.
Oh. Put Lightbane into the 1/3, Kraken the 4/3,
Well,
and then
we'll put
Flood.
Lightbane into the 1/3 and we'll play Swashbuckler. Let's go with that. Let's get our draw first, yeah. It's always a recurring thing. Not bad. Yeah, we can still crack in the 4/3. Yeah, we'll put him on the far right.
And then push five face.
I think we're happy trading for Flamestrike. Like we're in such a good position regardless with the Kraken. Like he'd need hard removal and AoE, so you need Polybore Flamestrike, and even then you just drop Ronin and you're fine. So with the last turn, just once again a small efficiency thing, right? Where you want to just, you know, if you know the Fuel Eye is killing the other thing and you know you're probably Krakening, that means that it leaves one mana for the Swashbuckler. That's kind of how I do my early assessment for the turn. I'm like, okay, so what's my most likely play? I probably want to Kraken his guy. That means the 3-power minion kills the taunt. That means I have one more mana. That means I play Swashbuckler. Okay, that means Swashbuckler is a card draw. That means I probably want to do that first. So I don't want it to die to the AoE, so I'm going to put the 3 into his dude. Then I want to draw. Maybe I get lethal somehow. I don't think we had a lethal draw. Maybe if, I don't think if a fireball would have done it, but it just gives you a little bit more,
Yeah.
gives you a little bit more insight on what your hand is and gives it, makes it easier to go with the right play. And I know that sounded really cocky, guys, with the the disagree on people saying the SAP, but it's one of the things that annoys me when there's people in the chat going off what just happened. Yeah, we just go. Like people look at what exactly happened and they're like, oh, well, he had a Belcher. Oh, well, then obviously keeping the SAP was correct. But if you look at what you're playing against, you look at, you know, you're playing against the mage, you look at what you sapped, you look at the shredder, you look at the probability of him removing rather than developing on his five. It is correct to sap the shredder there. And I just don't like it that people just go like, oh, look at what happened now. Obviously it was wrong to sap the sub the Belcher. I really don't like that that reasoning, right? The hindsight logic.
Yeah, well, you don't know that he has the Belcher, right? Immediately. Like, it's you can't look at it.
And even if you think about it, right? If you had developed double two, right? That's what we're thinking. You're developing the 3-2 and the 2-3. Even if he just has one little thing like a frostbolt, he frostbolts your taunt, he trades into your micro for free, or kills your crowd favorite. You are done because your sap is not doing anything. He didn't develop. Your tempo is gone. Your opponent has complete control. He's a mage. The game is slowed down and you've kind of lost, right? That's just what happens. The mage is completely comfortable. As if you sap there, even if he plays a five, you're still in control. You're still deciding what's happening. You still don't give him a good way to use removal. So it's just better. That's pretty much it. Okay, okay. All right, so we're at four wins. That's good. Well, overall,
you're officially at my worst or my best average with my worst class. So, so Shadow and Sprint are going. I don't like Pint Size as a turn two play, and I don't think we have enough to count on a draw, so we could also dagger. So I'm fine with tossing everything.
I agree. I think we are looking for something slightly more powerful than the Pint Size. We are looking for a backstab or poison, a swashbuckler, those kind of things, a creeper maybe.
A shield bearer.
Has its place, not on turn one, but has its place.
Well, we got the creeper, so. Yep.
Creeper does a lot of work in the early game. Oh, a mage that coins on one. That's pretty aggressive. Ah, we can see why.
So if we dagger, we take five.
We take nine, right?
Yeah. We end up taking nine. If we creeper, I think he pings the creeper.
That would be kind of weird, but I'd be very happy if he does that, honestly. So I'm really happy playing the creeper here. Like, if he does that, you can just trade in your guys, right?
Yeah, I mean, the other line is we take nine or he just pings the Thespian and we take three.
Yeah, Thespian's not an option here. It's Creeper or Dagger, and Creeper's just fine. Like, it's a really nice minion against this. Like, pinging the Creeper here is just wrong. I think it's probably better to ping the face, honestly. Assuming that he coined this out without a follow-up. Sure.
Called it.
I mean, this is good for us, right?
Yes, he just
exchanged four mana with two mana, and we don't have to take extra face damage.
So we burgle. That's that's happening.
Yep.
So I like card draw.
We have the option, if we wish, to dagger here. That is, if we want to play the Thespian or whether we want to dagger.
I like the dagger and put the 2/1/1s into the 3/2 to clear down his hero power.
No, I mean, if you're daggering, you're taking three, right? That's the whole point of the dagger?
Yeah, yeah.
So that means you'd be left with three power rather than four. 3 power maybe just enough. Yeah, I think the dagger's fair here, but you're definitely taking 3. Why is Pink Reaper wrong? It gives your opponent 2 power rather than 1, Mashiban. It gives them a lot more options. It will give us the option, for instance, say we had a Micro Machine and we wanted to develop that. We could have just played Micro Machine on this turn without having to dagger to kill the 3-2. If he had pinged our face, he wouldn't have been in this position right now.
And he just pinged again. So I think the crowd favorite.
We're actually quite happy abusing a slow player and going for the pint size and the pompous. This puts us in a position where we're going to start discounting our minions. And we also just develop more power.
Okay, so Pompous on the left, and then.
You can put pompous on the right and pint sized on the left. Reasoning here is that pint sized is your tech minion, which you generally want to keep to the far left. It doesn't matter in our particular deck because there is no dog. I guess we have a shredder. We have the possibility of getting a dog, so it still matters. Yeah, that's good. Sure.
Well, we're sapping the thing, right? That's happening.
Yeah, I think we're just sapping and playing crowd favorite, right?
Yep.
Yeah, and this is just an example of an opponent that played for a very slow game. And he can definitely recover. That's pretty good. Another sap, please.
So I think I like. Well, no matter what, the two healths die, so we don't want to use the four. The question is whether we want to take four to the face.
Why?
Yeah, well, yeah, okay. So it wouldn't change the outcome at all. I mean, we might as well trade the dead minions.
The 1-1 and the 3-2 go in, put the Cyclotron on the far right, push the four face. It sucks, but that's what he did. At this point, we're kind of committed to being aggressive. Like, he got too much value out of that A-bomb. A-bomb was really good there. We know he still has Belcher in hand, so we need Deathlord in hand, so we need to be wary of that. Crossbow, sure.
I think we draw and see what we
Yep,
get.
sounds like a plan. Redagger first for Mana Psycho, sure. That would have been a thing. I don't think it's going to matter, but it would have indeed been a thing.
So he still has a Death Lord for taunt. This doesn't die if he pings the shield and trades the Ellie.
Oh yeah, the dagger wouldn't have worked. Sorry guys, no, it was a misplay to redagger first. Yeah, this
Push
is a it's
the
a
three face and hit him in the face with a dagger and redagger.
No, you played MC Tech and just push three phase and pass. Like, redaggering here is too slow, right?
Yeah, he can't.
Like,
He's
we
gonna
need
have to do
we need
something else to kill the Cyclotron, so yeah.
Yeah, we need to kill him. He's got too many cards. We're not gonna do the long game. It's gonna be very rough because we don't have that much reach.
Please do that first. That's fine.
Looks like he really wants to play 4 mana. Maybe he thought that it would get frozen.
So we're sapping the Death Lord.
Not always.
No.
I think we lead with a fan here and see where we stand. It's gonna be a long turn, so go with that.
No. We can assassinate the Death Lord and see what we get.
About to say, that looks like a pretty fair assassinate. Let's do it. Easy medieval, let's go. I'm okay with just the body. Oy, look at that body.
3-3 goes into the 4-3.
Yep.
This is in flame strike range regardless, so do we just full clear his board then? Or no, actually I think we push face. We have Kraken in hand.
I think you trade because of Portal. I think Portal's a little bit too devastating here if you leave that up.
Okay.
The assassinate could have been game winning here if we just pull the Shredder or Panda or Tiger, but this looks pretty sad. Torch, sure.
We crack in the Psychotron. Trade the burglar, crack in the Psychotron.
Why would you take a burglar?
Oh, that's all right. Yeah, we have a dagger, so we pop with dagger and crack in the Psychotron.
Yeah, I'm just taking my time here to see if we ever try to set up anything, but I don't think so. I think it's too slow.
Yeah, I don't think Shet. Yeah, I
It
agree.
feels like
I don't
the
think Shet
Kraken's just
checks.
gonna get dealt with. That's the thing, right? And then our pressure's gone, but I think it's correct. Yeah, so face into the shield, Kraken his dudes, push the one. So no read on his hand, right? No thing that we sap that's still there.
Nope.
Sure.
Okay. Think we've Medivh re-dagger.
That'd be a very bad ordering, right? Because
Yeah.
you'd destroy your staff.
Yeah.
I'm actually quite happy playing the Medivh and sapping the 3-2 here. I think that he may be blizzarding this to prep it for Flame Strike, and if you Medivh sap, the Medivh will live. We should have thought about putting one face with our thing. I don't think it was correct though, but just to think if we had maybe lethal, because he'd go to 11, would have 8, 9, 3 damage. I don't think we have 3 in our deck, no. I think we have 2. He is very dead at the moment.
Shadow Strike the Thespian and clean it up.
Sure. Either that or the 1/4. I don't think we can get a minion that prevents lethal. Camel Pogchamp. Nice. GG. So looked a little hairy after the A bomb, but he kind of didn't do that much, and we got an assassinate on a Death Lord, even though it only got us a 1/1. It still was a pretty good deal.
Yeah, the trade-off was, yeah, we got the 1/1 that time, but we had enough in our deck where we had a higher chance of pulling a 3 cost or higher, so.
Why not Valiant and hit with a weapon? I think either was fine there. You still had Shadow Strike to get through a thing, the sap summon the dude as well. I don't know, maybe I'm a little bit too stingy on the weapon charges. We're all good to go, by the way. I think it would have been fine to Valiant there as well. I think I just put it on a binary thing, sap yes or no. Should have probably used the Valiant. I don't think it mattered too much. I guess we could have gotten Doomsayer, so yeah, that was kind of risky. I guess it is a legit misplay, the sap there.
So I think we just toss Fan. I mean, Fan's good against his what? His 1/1 totem. I like so, sapping.
Why are you keeping this up?
Well, I'd like sap early. I'm just trying to run through what Shaman would have. I mean, he's got the 4-mana 7/7, but over the course of 4 turns, chances are we draw another sap. Or a way to deal with it. So I think Sap and Fan goes.
Why would you keep MCT?
As a 3-drop.
I like the Burglar and the Sap here. I don't think we need the MCT. I like the Sap for the 7/7 as well. I don't think that MCT adds enough to want it this early. Once again, it's all about... Think about it like this. If you're keeping something, you're also denying yourself a chance to get something better. So it's not so much like, MCT will do. It's like... Am I denying myself a chance here to hit, say, a Creeper, a Backstab, a Shredder, a Poison, right? Some of the exciting early game cards. And you kind of are. Yeah, so play the Burglar. I think it's something that I really focus on a lot when I'm playing together with other people. It's the big difference in mulliganing. I mulligan much more aggressively for my good cards. Oh, look, he's good at the game.
I think we just Creeper.
Just play it so we have a Shredder, we have MCT if we fall really far behind, we have a reactive card in the Stormcrack, the Sap. I'm still feeling fairly confident even after the Juggler.
Think we just blood sail? I mean,
why?
I guess MCT would be fine as a 3. Oh, Coin Shredder would work too.
I was about to say, why are we not Coin Shreddering here? It's like pretty good. Next turn we can Dagger Blood Sail or MC Tech if he plays into it. It's pretty good.
And then push the one face, correct?
Yeah, push the one face. Popping it into the 3/3 is kind of okay. But I think this is okay. Your mulligan wizardry make me realize I'm way too conservative with mulligans. I've been more optimistic lately and I think we're doing much better. Yeah.
Oh, there's the dagger.
Oh dear god, we're getting Shrek'd on our... Oh, yes, one drop, go. Let me steal your shit. Wow, he's not killing it. Wow. What?
Okay.
Why would you not kill the things then? Alright. Weird. That's just wrong, right? He just pushed less damage and took damage on his Zubat rather than his Juggler.
Yeah, and then overloaded his turn 5, so he can only do a 3 drop or 3 mana. So I think Dagger Bloodsail, the original thing, is still a thing here.
Yep. Dagger Blood Sail and kill the Spell Power Totem.
Yep.
A little bit too good if he keeps having that weapon. It also saves your spider, it's fine. Yeah, that just made no sense, I don't know. That felt very weird.
Oh, that's why. He was gonna Blood Sail for that.
Yeah,
five.
Well, why does it matter? It's still a misplay, right? He should have just
yep.
used this guy. Yeah, I don't know. Weird. Very weird. Trey weird.
I think he's Psychotron, right? I mean, we could Fan for draw.
I think that your two available plays here are Psychotron or Stormcrack the 3/3. Play them MCT and then have Psychotron available next turn. The reason why I don't like the Stormcrack play that much is that it gives him a very, very clean Fire Rally on your MCT. So I kind of like the Psychotron here and make it a bit uncomfortable with the Fire Rally. Just chill. That's one of the things you really want to look at, what your opponent's most likely move is or one of his best moves, and then make it worse, because MCT Stormcrack just plays right into Fire Rally. Kind of feels like he's got it. Oh wow, trade? Please trade. Yes! Oh man, what a Psychotron! What a Bows! It's like a Sunwalker. Mini
the
Sunwalker.
Value.
That felt good, guys.
CT. So we end up floating one, we Stormcrack, and then MCT the Belcher.
Yeah, so normally it'd be could be
like
a reasonable sap as well.
So you're thinking sap MCT?
It's just not that much different. Next turn we're gonna have six mana again. Yeah, I think Stormcrack kill this guy and MCT is fine. It's very close with the sap here. This is the more awkward draw where we'd much rather have a Spiteful over an additional sap, but I think if you sap, you make it a little bit too easy to play another Belcher.
Yeah.
I guess then we could sap it again, which is not bad, but we don't really have pressure.
Oh, the Micro Machine dies.
Yeah, very nice pickup. So backstab the machine. And then
fan for draw.
Yep, fan looks good. This is a proper rogue hand. It needs Medivh.
Dagger down the 1/1.
Yep, just dagger down the dude. It's all good. You love my new recipe. Phase three, go. No. Shadio, thanks so much for the 13 months in a row, man. Awesome, more than a year of support. Appreciate it.
Toad Shadow?
I almost want to like use the sap, but I don't think it's correct. Yeah, I think Toad Shadow Pan's fine.
Like, yeah, I don't want his Alchemist coming back to do things later. Or...
Yeah, it's just not. Yeah, it's fine. We just go with the Totem and Shadow Pan. I think we stab his Totem.
Make him roll for healing?
Yeah, I mean, if he rolls a healing, it's not like we're short on mana right now, right?
Yeah.
It's relevant for now. Like, even if it's healing, we don't care too much. And this just gives us the option to get past the taunt. Ha, wrecked.
Sap the Zubat. Clear the totem. Push six face. Set
yeah,
up lethal.
We like that more than Kraken here. Yep. Taunt totem again would be annoying.
That is true.
But I think we can stabilize them with just using Kraken. Sure. It's alright, even with, like, especially with the Chao, we don't feel too pressured.
Okay, so
Currently one off lethal.
yeah, one off. Well, he's gonna push phase, so what if we kill the Chao? Push the Shadow Pan into the Chao, resap the Zubat.
Why are we sapping this turn?
Was trying to clear off the board.
Let's just crack in the 3-3, put the 3-6 into the 2-3, put the face into the 1-1. That means he's dead next turn. Like, the Kraken's body, so this is a pretty good one, right? This is a. I feel this is a pretty good tell on where you're going wrong as well with Rogue. Is that. There's a little bit too much focus on just killing whatever he has, which is generally right with Rogue, but you don't want to take that too far up to the point where you're not developing a 9-7. Oh, GG. Like, the Kraken itself is just lethal next turn, and your hand is pretty much like, well, whatever he plays is dead. Now, I do get that it's a little scary to play your only threat. Oh. So scary that he ditched me. See if he's still here. What a perfect timing just after the game. Panic basket. Skype, please. Let's give him a call. See if he's here. Rage quit. Yeah. Pff. Only 6-1. What is this fucking coaching? What did you do, Shady? Sorry, guys. We spooked him. In before, please rate the quality of your call. Insta one star. Yeah. He's offline right now. So I'll tell you what, guys. I'm quickly gonna grab something to eat. And then I think we'll wait around 5, 6 minutes. We'll just do some Q&A, right? You guys can ask me whatever. If he's not back then we'll finish the coaching session later or at another day. So be right back, guys. Quickly gonna grab my food. We're definitely gonna continue playing, right? It's either with him or we'll bring on Ellie Spot. Is the mission coming after this run? Yes, after this run, we are going on a mission. We are going on a beast spell druid mission. It's gonna be pretty good, guys, so be right back.
Oh, sorry. I'm sure you guys could hear that. Oh. Alrighty, guys. Let me see if he's here. I think he's here. Hey, what's up, man? Can't hear you right now. If you're talking.
Can you hear me? Type something if you do. Oh shit, did he went offline again? Did he went? Yes, very good English. My English very good, guys. You could say that three sneezes in a row is cold incoming. No, it's more just like half allergy thing. Q&A, what are you eating? Rice with spinach, chicken, some soy sauce. I think he may have disconnected while calling.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so
hey, what's up, man?
I apologize for the cat that knocked the router off the entertainment system.
I would fire the cat. Like, sorry, cat, it's not working out. You may have to find a different owner.
Yeah, my wife would get rid of me before she got rid of her cat.
At least you know where you stand, right? All right, so you good to go?
Yep. I still show 6-1, but did the other guy leave?
We won. I think you had lethal, right? Oh, did we not actually? I think he may have conceded. This could be one of those miracle stories if he didn't concede. Oh my god. Guys, the opponent could have won. Damn. All right.
Oh.
Damn. Mm-mm.
Okay. On the menu, let me get the sharing thing.
No, we're good, right? You just queue up. I'm just spectating you, right?
Yep, that's fine.
We only need the screen share after the rewards. But I got them here, so it's fine. You can just leave it running if it's cool for you.
Yep.
All right, let's rogue some more people. Rogarino. Very good, very good.
Oh, just a second, Shady. Mm-hmm. Give me, calm down. Yeah, cat's gonna be I gotta grab the cat. It's gonna be bad.
Okay, go for it, dude. Shady, you need to repeat what you said after the game since he didn't hear it. What did I say, man? What did I say? I say so much. Half of it you don't need to believe. It's feeling, right? So when I say that Hunter is a bad class, I don't actually mean it. No, I actually can't remember. What I said right then. Even the cat is sick of you playing wizard poker. Too good. Where's the chicory? I haven't had chicory in a long time, Ellie. It could be a thing. Maybe I could be eating chicory again. Mm-mm. Yeah, I actually had a tie going as well, Ellie, but this particular shirt is a little bit too tight. I feel like this when I have the tie, so we opted to unbutton a little bit. You were talking shit the whole time because you're a mean coach. Wow, feels bad, man. Shady Bunny debunked. Exposed for what he truly is. I knew it. Shady secretly thinks Hunter's the best class, spreads misinformation so no one else plays it. I want Hunter so desperately to be good, but I don't think it's going to happen this expansion either. They've systematically just made it worse and worse. Now as well, right? Removing Cobra Shot on top of it. Yeah. Mm-mm. Hunter sucks so bad. I think Warrior's probably still worse, Juke, but yeah. It's very feels bad, man, for the bad classes to do this expansion as well. Hunter would be good if they removed the cheat. Man, not even. There's just, I don't know. I just feel like it's too honest. It's too honest. You said about developing. Ah, yes. Okay. Thank you, Justeo. Appreciate it. Tried so hard and got so far. Yeah, Juke, sing it. Sing it, baby. Opinion on Fool's Bane? It's good. It's good. If you have Violet Illusionist, you win the game. But it's just a little bit too gimmicky to kind of bank the whole class on. Warrior was fine. Why is it worse again? No more Ghoul. No more Nezzoth's first mate. What else was being pushed previous expansion? What was the last one? Not the last one. A couple of Bloodhoof Brave was also being pushed. It was just, yeah. Old Gods was pretty kind to Warrior, I feel. Very taunty, very slow, very valuey. You could go super fat. Start, please? I would, but my student is currently doing God knows what to the cat, so. No more Obsidian. Well, Obsidian wasn't pushed in Old Gods either, right, Ellie? Obsidian was, I guess you could call it in the mini meta, Obsidian was a little bit more there.
Okay, the
Hey, you
cat is
back?
secured. The cat is secured.
The cat is secured. The cat's in the bag. All right, very good. Let's go. We got it, boys. We're going in. We're going in with the rouge. Ooh, versus Pally. Okay.
Now, I haven't played against a paladin since the grand tournament where they had the muster opener.
They've lost a lot of their fangs, but 6-1 Pally probably still has some of those cards.
So I think we dump Psychotron and keep Creeper and Toad.
Why are we keeping 2/2 drops?
Oh, I like Toad on the off chance it can remove like a shield off a mini bot or,
It
well,
would
I guess that wouldn't matter.
that wouldn't work, right? He'd kill it.
Yeah. So we keep the creeper and toss the rest.
Yep, excellent. Keep the creeper. Gives us more chance to find poison, backstab, swash burglars, 3 drops. Yeah, there we go. That worked out.
Swashburglers.
So once again, a little bit
Oh.
more aggressive mulliganing. Hey, I'll take it. Not a terrible card here, guys. 8 mana, 8/8 with a minor upside. Pretty all right. Damn.
Second burglar, push the 1/1 into his scarab if we leave him with stuff that he can buff.
Explain to me why we would develop our second burglar over one of our 2/2 drops this turn.
Because I like cards.
The card will still come if you play it later, you know?
So we drop the creeper and then we remove his scarab, right?
I don't really feel the need to kill a scarab. I don't think there's much he can do. I'd rather play Creeper and go face. I think it's a trade he has to make. So this is good. This is really good, by the way. Key, like, don't feel like you're doing poorly at all. You're doing great when we're doing coaching, right? This is exactly the stuff I need. Just being honest and talking about your stuff. This is gonna make you so much better at the game, because you're already doing pretty well, right? You're averaging 5 or something.
Yeah, between 4 and like 5.5. depending on the class.
So doing these little things, like not drawing your cards until you need them and working on your mulligan, that's pretty simple to fix. So that's going to increase your results by quite a bit more. This is it's going to be very good for the future. Right, so what do we do now?
Dagger, burglar,
well,
clear
burglar,
the 1-1.
We burglar first, right? See what we get, and then we maybe dagger, maybe not. I don't think we need the dagger this turn. I think we're pretty happy just playing the Pompas and using the creeper, what it was designed for. Just free killing a dude.
Dagger, clear, push both. Or we can pop the spider, but we'd still end up daggering, right?
Yeah, I'm just trying to find out if I ever play the valve in this turn. So we're definitely daggering up. We're okay using our face into that, and we're pushing face with our dudes. I don't think I play the ball. I think I keep it. Oh, 1 second, I'm just gonna turn off the dryer. Machine just keeps beeping.
It's like, I'm ready.
It's like, I know, shut up. All right, things, what are we doing?
Pop his 3/3. Like, we could sap the 3/3, but I really don't want to give him a chance to actually put it out as a 4/4 with a spare part.
No, we have a very clean kill on it, right? Just use our face and the dudes.
So we can re-dagger Vilefin. Not a fan of the 3/7 for 5 since we don't have a way to combo it.
I definitely play the 3/7. You can choose to either develop a 1/3 hero power and get some stuff, or to play a 3/7. A 3/7 is much more tempting. So we could do something cute here with Vilefin dagger and then also summon the dude, seeing as the hero power would become active again. But it's so slow. Like, you have 4 power in total. You have no durability. Especially with a heavy hand like this, there's no reason to go so slow.
Dagger fan clear.
Fan looks good. Let's do that
fan,
first.
Yeah, fan draw first. And then... So he was pulling around.
You all right?
Yep.
What are we doing here?
So a dagger, kill the 2/1. Trade the... No?
Dagger, poison, kill the 3/2.
Yeah, okay.
3/7 into the 2/2, 1/1 into the 2/1. Push one face.
And then push one face, yeah.
That looks better. So once again, this is the being too conservative with your resources thing again, right?
Up and down. Like, he stopped twice right here.
Yeah.
If you need to go, you need to go, but then we'll end it here. I'll put it like that. That's up to you.
We're good.
We're good?
Dealing with animal issues.
Animal control. Come help.
The cat is trying to ruin the arena run.
I don't have pets, man. I can't deal with pets.
We sap the 3-1, push the 1-1 into the 2-1, and then 3 face and play fork.
We're playing fork this turn. That's that much I know, so put it down. Let me just think on this for a sec, because if we go here, here, here. Yeah, we actually don't need to go that slow. We're fine using our face and the 1-1 into the 3-1. So face okay. And the 1-1 into the 3-1. And then we'll put the 3-3 into the 2-1. Then we'll re-dagger first, and then we'll put down the Vilefin. Okay. That gives us a lot of options. So that means next turn, Light Lord heals either your face or a panda back to 7, which is also kind of cool.
Yeah, which is great.
You also keep your sap. Even though sapping Crusader isn't terrible there, I kind of want to get the Vilefin down. We're at around the time where we don't really want to dagger any Mage that much, and we do have the Deadly Fork.
They might have stormed.
Sap Shredder Hero Power?
Cider Dat or Shadow Strike. Trade off your 1-3 or take the damage. Shredder comes down, that's for sure. I think we're plenty happy with the Sap Hero Power. It's fine. I'd preserve the weapon. Yeah, do we? We do have a fork. Let's push our dude's face and do some math. No, we're making a dude, right? The dude happens.
Yeah, we're making a dude.
We're just thinking about the face here. If we push it, he's at 18. We have 6, 10, 11, 12, 16. I think you're fine hitting it just because of the fork. It's okay. Like, we don't care if he has Stormwind in the hand. Stormwind's pretty bad for him anyway. Ready, sir. Follow the rules.
Shadow Strike the 4-4, SI the 2-2.
So this is another thing that I've noticed you doing, which is something what a lot of people do. It's they prioritize clearing the board over doing a slightly more awkward clear, but also developing at the same time. So if you just crack in the 4-4
here. So crack in the 4-4?
Yeah, if you crack in the 4-4 here, you still have plenty. So you can start with that, crack in the 4-4. I think you're actually perfectly fine putting the fork into the 3-3, and then your Murloc you put your face into the 2-2, and then we think about whether we use our Vilefin. I don't want to use Shredder because of potential Doomsayer. I think we're fine using the 1-3 and then face with the rest. So the reason why we use the fork is that means we have access to an additional 3 damage next turn.
Cool. Yeah, you're starting to bring me around to the fork.
Yeah, it's been okay, right? I really didn't like it at the start, but it's just one of those things that, like, it does 3 damage like most 3 drops, and then you just get a fork, and it's not that bad. It's not great for the early game, but it's in the mid game, it's actually kind of okay. Well, all right, and he is pretty dead. Well, Light Lord boys, all right, that's infinite. Good stuff.
Are you good to spin?
Yeah, good to go.
Thank you. So against Druid, generally you want to go fast, right?
Our deck, not necessarily. There's a lot of fast druids these days. It's really touch and feel to see where they go. Why do you ask, may I ask? Is it anything to do with this mulligan?
Yeah, I'm just trying to consider what we have in the deck versus what I'd toss and hope to draw.
Right, let me in your decision making.
Well, we keep the burglar no matter what. We like the burglar. I think crowd favorite goes, even though it's hard. We have a coin. I got 10 seconds, so
Just keep the
it's.
burglar, throw the rest once again. For me, this is a pretty straightforward mulligan, so I'm trying to understand why there is so much hesitation for the I'm assuming the tiger or the MC tech. Which one did you want to
Yeah,
keep?
for the tiger.
So yes, we don't have that many good fives. We do have three, so it's like we're maybe s yeah, actually we're kind of on track with those. So by keeping the tiger, once again, give yourself less chance to land that backstab, that poison, the swashburglar, a second one, just all those nice early game cards.
Yeah.
But it's good. Keep doing this, right? Don't just do stuff because you think that's what I would do. Do things that you would do on your own, and then, like I said, if you're gonna watch a replay of the coaching session, it's gonna be a lot of value.
So he hero powered on two. Micro Machine goes to a 3/2 on our turn if it lives versus Pompous.
I think that the Pompas is not a consideration here. I think it's either the micro or the coin fork.
Yeah, coin. I think I like coin fork as a
I don't think
to
so.
power out. I
We
think.
don't need it right now. Sorry if I'm throwing you off, by the way, but I play the micro machine right now because the fork deals as much damage as a micro machine, but you do preserve your coin. I also like the fact that if we fork next turn, we can get fork plus deadly poison out on turn four as a surprise effect, which is pretty nice as well. Whereas if you coin the fork now, that's not really an option, and he'll play around the three damage if he can.
Yeah, so even if he drops the Micro Machine, we're setting up to have a 5/2 weapon on turn four.
Well, on top of this, we also have the kind of sneaky shield bearer here if we want it. Ooh.
Yep.
right, let's think on this for a sec. You're good to keep playing, or?
Yes. I'm gonna throw the dog away.
I would say you don't sound very confident. right. Let me know when you're ready to
Okay,
execute the play.
I'm good. I just shoved her out the door.
Okay. All right, let's dagger up and equip the poison.
Okay, so we dagger deadly, and then we're going to.
Coin the roots on his dude. Coin the roots for two damage on his bird, and then kill it with your face. Micro Machine goes face. And then next turn we have Shield Bearer plus SI to take down whatever he plays. Call PETA. That cat is actually barking. I think that's the dog. I think there's a cat and a dog.
That's the cat is actually bigger than the small dog.
Oh wow, okay. So that's more like a Chihuahua. It's something
Yeah,
in that
about that
range.
size.
About. All right, has to go for the wrath. Hopefully there's no follow-up.
Oh, alternatively, he could have wrathed to draw a card, right? And then hero power the Micro Machine down.
Yeah, that was a lot. I think he could have Druid of the Fang, but this doesn't make sense.
We fork and clear the wolf.
I think I like the Shield Bearer plus SI to ping his guy. I'm not 100% sure though, because we do have a lot of forms of three damage should the fork go through. If we were to use our face and then fork, next turn we'd have 5 mana. 5 mana means we can still trade in 3/2/2. Bum, bum, bum. Yeah, I think I may like the other line a bit more. Yeah, I think face into the dog and play the fork is actually correct. I think we can hold on the shield there. I don't think it's necessary yet. Especially now, because if he plays Root of the Claw, you can just trade in your 3, equip your 4, trade it in, and then play Thespio. Or just that, and then... sure. That's fine.
So... we have Backstab Fan. We'll cycle us a card.
No real need for the fan here, though, right?
He can backstab SI. Can backstab face. SI. Yeah. Yeah, that'll work, I think. He can backstab clear the 3-3 with face and then SI his face.
That's a little bit too fast, right? There's something which is like one gear lower. You're very well on the way. What's one gear lower?
So we drop the Pompous,
yeah,
backstab, yeah. Clear face, and put the Pompous?
Yeah, backstab, dagger is due to play the Pompous. So I know that it's tempting to play on curve, right? To play the 3 mana card, but it's just not necessary here. Just not necessary to waste your SI Battlecry.
Yeah, okay, yeah, especially going into 6 when we can fan and then SI for 3 on the whatever.
You're putting as much power on the board as well, right? It's not like you're developing a tremendously low amount of power. All right, easy sap up the top, baby! Wanna get a mulch?
Wanna get a mulch?
Yeah. I mean, let's play the burglar, see what we get.
Yeah, let's hope for a mulch. That's not a mulch.
It's most definitely not.
So, SI. Trade the fork and face and push Pompous into his.
That doesn't we kill could... it. That's only 6 damage, right?
Oh, one off.
Alright, put the SI down. Hit his ogre with the SI. Go face with all your other dudes, including your... Yeah, use the face in his face, but play the shield bearer. So face, 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 shield bearer. So... this is a bit tough whether you want to re-dagger or face. I think you have fork, so the chance you're going to want to equip fork next turn is quite high. I don't just want to re-dagger here. I want to play the shield bearer because I don't want him to say have 2 damage to get through the Pompous Thespian and then trade into the 3-3. We've kind of committed to an aggressive line because we're drawing very light. He went very wide. Yeah, so this is kind of where the shield bearer does its thing. So, didn't get hit in the face for 6 in this particular line. It's still pretty bad, right? He had Starfire.
Yeah.
But I don't think we win if we double trade. We just kind of win for him. It's pretty sad.
Fan to draw?
Don't really like anything here. I think you just fork tech and hit him in the face for 3. I think at this point you're committed. Starfall GG, yeah, but like I said, guys, I don't think you beat a Starfall. If the play around Starfall was to put both your 3 power minions into his ogre and his Saiyan, you're running out of steam and you're putting yourself in a position where he can just play another big minion and then you lose, right? It's just unfortunate that we have 2 saps and an assassinate and we just haven't seen any.
We haven't even seen really anything above 4 cost.
So he had a bog, right? So we wouldn't have won no matter what.
Fan for draw?
Yeah, fan, try to hit that sap or assassinate, I feel. If we have a chance, that's probably it. Nope.
Psycho, I guess. I mean, He's gonna end up taking three to the face and then trading the ogre in, I'm sure, but
thinking if Toad is ever better, whether he just trades a 6-1 in out of paranoia. I think so. I don't think you can afford to throw your psycho away.
So Toad and
Toad
Hope.
And Chill. I think the fork is okay. I've really come around on the fork as well, guys. I used to start off with not liking a fork at all. Now I'm actually, I think it's now an okay card. I don't think it's anywhere near premium, but it's an okay card. It's like a filler. Oof. Rough. Oh, Prince Gallywix. Hey, pal. Great Prince Gallywix here. I like the stealth on the edge. Very nice. Establish dominance by not playing around Betrayal. So we're always dead.
Yep.
Even with Assassinate Coin Psycho. Okay, GG. Where's my car? That's all right. We weren't beating that no matter what, not with this draw. Because you can, like I said, you can make the argument that on the Starfall turn, oh, why didn't you trade all your guys in the ogre? But then, you know, he plays the bog. You don't have a board anymore and you lose. And he just still has Starfire in his hand. Or Starfall, rather. I think it's just, we played it correct. He had to beat. We move on.
Sneaky Druids.
Yeah, Starfall is an amazing card.
Ditch Assassinate and go.
Yeah, premium start. We like this.
Hey, premium.
We will take it.
Creeper face. Or do we want to pop the shield?
I like Creeper pop the shield here. I think it's a little precaution around muster and rallying blade. Kink in the plans, got it.
Play silent, pop 1/1 with the creeper.
You mean kill the 1/1 with the creeper? Or...
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, pop just, the creeper. Like whenever I hear pop with a creeper, I'm just like, we're sure we're not, you know, running it into the 4/3. Yep, I like that. Hey, didn't have it.
No dragon synergy.
Feels good, man.
So True Silver, clear the 4/3. We remove his boar and we pop the shield on our knight and then pop our creeper on his 2/3.
Try
and just wipe his board.
Try approaching that turn again. Just from a logical standpoint.
So we're gonna True Silver, right?
Yes.
That's gonna happen.
We're gonna True Silver. So what's more logical than the play you just suggested?
Well, they both have 3 health, so we'd True Silver down the 2/3, take 2 less face damage.
Ah, yes, I like it. I like that much more.
True
Boop.
Very nice.
And then we set up for a blood sail next turn.
Oh yeah. Well, probably a five, but blood sails come down at some point.
Yeah. So, I like the tiger for the stealth. We're at a fairly high life total, so I don't think we need the psychotron.
So, we're always putting a 1-1 in his shield, right?
Yeah, we're going to pop his shield with a spider.
Okay, we'll do that. I think we're always killing his spell power, so I think we're putting the 2-2 into the spell power.
Yep.
So here, if you tiger, I feel you burn this charge on the 2-2. I don't like that. So that's why I like psychotron in one phase.
Okay.
I feel like in a normal circumstance, tiger is okay. But because we have true silver, we'd rather psychotron and push one phase. This way we have a lot of options for next turn. We still have our 4 damage equipped. Yeah, I'll take it.
Ready, sir.
So the burglar gets played no matter what, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep, start with that. Arrgh. Premium burgles this round. Damn.
So the question is, do I blood sail, clear his 4-4 with the true silver? Clear the 2-2 with the 3-4.
So that'd be a 6-3 rather than a 5-5. I think I'd rather have a 5-5 than a 6-3 this turn. So
yeah.
I think I'd play the tiger here. And then just face into the 4-4, 3-4 into the 2-2, one face.
So like when you're playing the paladin, right, you don't want to leave him with anything to buff, like you don't want him to have guys. Is that
unless it's a very awkward clear, yeah. You'd rather remove. But like the last one, the mini bot versus your shield is okay. Like even if he kings it, it's not that bad.
We pop the shield. Okay, so we pop the shield with the 1-1.
Sure. What else are we doing?
The keeper.
No.
The 1-1.
Oh. Dagger up. Play the blood sail. Put your face and the psychotron into his psychotron. Put the 5-5 and the 2-3. Push one face. So, I thought about this as well for a long time because it's an awkward turn to spend your mana properly, and then I came to the conclusion, you don't have to. Like we have
just
things,
just
right?
Just float 3.
He can't play anything what we're not prepared for with his hand, so. Like, we don't have to tempo out. We're fine.
So I can keeper that and trade the 3-3, which gives us 6 to the face. I can assassinate, which gives us more, and then leaves us with a fork. I think that's better. Assassinate the creeper and play a fork and push face.
Normally I'd say yes, and it might still be the play. We just have Medivh, so I'm just thinking if it's relevant to keep the spell. Hey, Sanoja, thanks much for the 8 months. I have a reaction video up for the arena ban list. It's going to be easier. You just watch that.
Yeah, but we still have sprint, right?
Yeah, so I think I'd be getting a little bit too greedy here. So I think assassinate and fork will do just fine. I'm okay pushing our face as well. We have the fork. this poor guy. We rope him while assassinating his Law Creeper. Probably a little salty over that. But it was legit a good alternative with the Keeper. So.
So I think we Medivh 5-3 into the 6-5 and 3-2 into the 2-3. Put 4 in the face.
The outer line is with the Aldor, but I think the Medivh probably does more. Let's see. So if we go with the Older Man and the Pine Sights, this would be at 3. Dude, well, dagger.
We get. Oh, I'm sorry. But we get more through to face if we Aldor the 6-5.
Yeah, I actually like keepering the Lord. And then you can put your fork into either one. And then you equip the fork, kill the other one.
Then weapon.
Yeah, kill the other one. And then I'd play the Pine Size, because why not? I think this is better than Medivh this turn. Like, he's just dead next turn, so there's no need for the Medivh.
Yep. GG.
Like, you could say, like, oh man, we're gonna set up the sick Medivh sprint value, but he's dead, right? He doesn't need to be more dead.
Yep. I'm gonna grab a bottle of water. Would you like one, Shady?
I've got one here, but thank you for the consideration.
Okay.
Unless water was some code for vodka, then probably still not, because I'm streaming. Play the fork, weapon, then hero power. Yes, good plays, good plays. Medivh never played. Well, Medivh's there for insurance, right? If we're threatening to get outgunned in a late game, we just Medivh, right? So if they're going really slow, you just Medivh. But if you're winning, you don't need to win harder, right? Poor Medivh. Not more dead, feels bad, man. I feel like Twitch chat is an expert at overkill. It's like, no, you can deal 40,000 damage, but he's on 3 health. I don't care, deal the 40,000 damage. It's like, wait 5 turns so you can deal 40,000 damage. That's how I imagine Twitch chat. And I don't think I'm very far off. He offered you a bottle of water. Does that mean he's in the other room? Just go like, ooh, he's got a bottle of it.
All right, Shade, you'll be pleased to know I have water and the cat is now sleeping, so we don't have to worry about him anymore.
Cat sleep? That's crazy.
Yeah.
All right, good to go, man. 40,000 damage, book champ. You don't really need to save your Elder Man there for a larger minion, Thresdet. Keeping your Tiger on the board, I feel, is more important. Cat dead it, call Pita.
Oh yeah, if we traded the Tiger in, we push less face, right? Mm-hmm. And face is obviously the place we want to go.
Yeah, I think it's more of a a thing where people like to keep their removal a little bit too long. Just like, you never know, man. He's gonna play stuff, but I mean, he's so dead. He's not playing things there, right? Okay. Playing against some more mages.
So keep Keeper and Backstab and toss the other two.
Creeper, Backstab. Yep, looking good. You already killed one cat. Don't kill the tiger too. I love these hands, man. Pretty nice.
We got a good combo going here.
Yep. Last game sponsored by Swashburglar. Pretty good.
Hello? think we just pass, right? I mean, we could coin Creeper, but we have another two.
Yeah, I like coining the Creeper here. I think it fits the curve very nicely. Creeper's one of those slow minions.
Then it leaves us with a backstab SI for another two down the road.
One option. I don't think it's terrible to pass here at all. I just think that if he plays a 3-2, you just dagger and kill it anyway, so you're pretty happy regardless.
So I like Toad more than Pint Size. The health is the same. Well, I guess it wouldn't technically matter. Pint Size will let us... Well, it's not going to help us go faster with SI.
No, it would allow you to dagger and Toad next turn. That's it.
Yeah.
Is that worth it? It might be. Yeah, I think Pint Size is fair here. Pint Size one phase. I don't think it's necessary to... Like, she's at her prime on turn two, right?
Yeah.
This is where it gets, like, the earlier the game, the more one mana ramp hurts. Like, turn five, getting an extra mana, sure, that's good, but doing it on turn turn two is pretty cool.
We're playing Beast Mage, so...
We are playing Beast Mage.
What if we Shield Bearer Toad?
What if we Shield Bearer SI?
And then trade the 1-1 or the 1-2 into the 1-1?
Yeah, I like that a lot actually. I think we put the Shield Bearer in the middle. Now we put the SI on the very far left, shooting the left Pantry Spider. And the Creeper kills off the Pantry Spider, and now we push 2 phase. That's a pretty nice aggressive start.
Yeah.
And takes away some of his power as well.
Shredder. Backstab the spider and trade our spider. Alternatively, we can Shredder, backstab the 2-4, and preserve the Shield Bearer.
I think it's perfectly fine to play Shredder and put the 3-3 into the 1-3 and then just push face. So Shredder in the middle, 3-3 in the 1-3, face with the rest. I don't think there's any need to overreact to what he has. Like, letting Shield Bearer die is fine, he's done his job. At first I was looking at backstab plus Toad. You'd backstab the 2-4, you'd dagger up, you'd use your 1-1 on your face into the 2-4, and then you'd free kill this guy. But for what reason? It's not necessary.
Put the Shredder into the 2-4. Backstab. Well, put the Shredder into the 2-4, see what we get.
It won't Might die get if a... you put it into the 2-4.
Sorry, what was that?
It won't die if you put it into the 2-4.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
So we'll put the Shredder into the 2-4. Start with that. We'll backstab his 2 and 2.
Mm-hmm.
We'll dagger up and use the 3-2 into his 4-4. We'll push face with the rest. And we'll develop... I think Huge Toad, I think he Blizzards here. So I kind of don't want to develop the micro. So this is, I feel, still pretty good. There's still a lot of pressure. Blizzard is still fairly bad. You're getting a 2-drop and a Creeper shot. We could have pushed way more damage but that opens you up to a lot of stuff. Now we still have some fairly heavy cards here. Okay. Wow. Nice right. shot. Could be relevant for Medivh.
Put the toad into the 2/3 and hope for a coin flip.
That won't happen. Our death rattle goes off before his.
No. We can still put the toad in, clear with the dagger. Use cut purse and to get a coin.
Yeah, I think you just play micro machine dagger on this turn and use toad dagger into his dude. Go face with rest. Do we ever play the MCT? Because we're pretty fucked anyway. Yeah, I think you play the MCT. If he has it, he has it. You're not beating Flingstrike in this position. I think we've played too conservatively. Beat Flamestrike. It's not necessarily wrong because Portal's pretty bad as well. But there was definitely a different route we could have followed with a lot more face in it. But looks like he doesn't have it, so that's good. It's very good. It's actually really good.
For it.
It's going to play into the fan here as well. He may have landed AoE there. We'll see.
So, fan, dagger...
Fan. We'll go from there.
Well, yeah. So, if we Valiant, we're playing further into the AoE that he may or may not have got. If we dagger...
So, we're talking either Valiant or Coin Panda here, I feel.
Yeah.
If you Coin Panda... I feel like you give him an out with big removal. Then again, it's a trade into the guy. I think we actually just dagger his dude. And then next turn we have a guarantee. Eh, we have the coin anyways. Well, daggering up, that's happening. How greedy is this guy? I think you just stab it with your face. I think it's fine.
So you just stab his face?
No, stab his guy with your face.
Okay.
And then pass.
Talking about greedy. Man.
I don't think that's greedy. I think that's stupid. Greedy plays usually have a goal in mind, right? Daggering his face here, I think, is just stupid. Ah, oh, I had it. Look at that greedy guy.
But we have two spiders.
Yeah, I have the Nova, so I'm pretty glad we held back on our guy.
Blood Cell Shadow?
Well, we can coin and play all the things, right?
We can do that if we want to go all in.
Well, I mean, if you're not going to go all in now, then how are you going to win? I will push face with face as well. We've got enough mana. Ideally, you want to spread out your threats for Cone. Now he just has to Cone the Pirate and all your good guys are frozen.
Now.
So next time you want to put the other guys on the far right, put the Panda on the left, have the spiders in the middle. Sure.
Trade the 3/2 and the spider in, clear it with face, and then put the 3/3 into the 1/2 and 6/7 into the face.
So that's 7 face as opposed to 6 goes in, dagger 1, that's also 7 face. You lose one guy, but that's fine. All right, face, into his Belcher, 3-2 and a 1-1 into his Belcher, 3-3 into the 1-2, 7 face, Thespian far right. Why spiders in the middle? I didn't get that. Kind of cold. Okay, Conan. There we go.
Where's the Medivh sprint combo, man?
Oh, wow. Prep vanish? Please don't.
Well, now you said it.
Oh, man. I think he's toast.
That's what he was cycling for, but it doesn't save him.
GG. I've got my tier list below DJ Vexal. So Mage Rogue and Druid. Why not 6-7 into 3-5? That would actually give him a second out with the Flame Strike. But with this particular play, he has very little outs because your 6-7 survives AoE. Plus your 6-7 survives Portal, which is pretty huge. Having a 6 plus health minion against Mage is pretty important these days. Alrighty, let's keep it going. Very nice, very nice. Yeah, like I said, Rogue is huge value for coaching most of the time. You just get so many nice, pretty nice decisions and little efficiency things that can really make the difference.
Why do I get a feeling it's going to be mages from this point forward?
Yeah.
I would toss all the things.
Yep. For sure. Not our best opening end yet.
Nope. Well, here's hoping he puts out like a mana worm or something and we can do something. Hey.
I'd rather not have him give him a mana worm.
So I think we blood sail.
Why?
Or just dagger?
Why would we blood sail?
Put a 2-drop out. Dies to what? Yeah, we could just frostbolt it. He's got a coin. So we
I mean,
coin
if you're playing a 2-drop, you'd play a Valiant, right, to contest this guy? If you were playing a 2-drop. I just don't understand why the Raider would be played here.
My value 2-3 is more than 3-2s.
Yeah, but a 2-3 doesn't really challenge the mana worm properly, right?
Yeah.
I just dagger here. Like, I was just really interested in why the Raider was coming out. Yeah. So by daggering here, you give him a tougher time to, you know, make his mana worm good. Like if he has a frostbolt, you play your guy, frostbolt, he goes face. It's a lot of tempo going on. Next turn, you get a pretty good play with poisoning up, play the raider, kill his guy, however you want to do that. It's a lot of options that way.
So we deadly poison this turn, no matter what, declare.
Yeah, we poison, kill his fallen hero. That's happening for sure. And then which one is a logical drop here?
Well, of course, we want the Blood Raider, of course.
Yep.
Our Blood Sail.
It dies to his coin ping play a 2-drop, but that's fine. At least he still has to use the ping.
So he's gonna hope. Please miss.
Arcane missiles.
Feels bad.
No. I think we shadow strike it. I mean, it's a weird turn. Like, if we put the 3-2 down and he has another spell, it's kind of.
If you're putting anything down, you'd put the 3-3 down, right?
Yeah, yeah. If we were gonna play anything, it'd be the 3-3 and float one.
I think that's totally fine. I don't think we need to react this heavily to a Flame Waker. I just played a 3-3 here. Next turn, he may play a Yeti. You could shadow strike the Yeti, finish off the 2-4 with your Valiant thing.
Okay.
Like, this is also not overreacting to what your opponent has put out. We're also Arena, right? And I mean, what's Flame Waker gonna do here? Like, if he Frostbolts it, you take 2 extra phase. It's fine. Hey, it's the play we talked about. Feels good, man.
And we get a card.
Sorry?
I said, and we get a card.
You mean the spare part? Or?
Yeah. So we Shadow Strike the Yeti.
Yep.
Valiant ping and face the Flame Waker.
Valiant for sure. But are we free killer with the 3-3 or use our face? I'm not entirely out yet.
Well, if we trade this, we kind of force him to ping next turn, don't we? Like, he's going to want to ping.
Mm-hmm.
Do we want that to happen? We kind of do. Yeah, I just take the free kill here. Keep the weapon.
Because if he's playing from behind, if he's playing 3 mana next turn, we can then taunt the Valiant and then Shadow Ban.
Yeah, I think that we just kind of want to manage our resources properly here. If we go with the face, he can just drop a Pit Fighter and we're pretty sad. This means Pit Fighter is no longer an option. You're not forcing him to ping, you're giving him ping value. Well, I just don't want him to Pit Fighter here, Koi. You see how it's awkward, whereas this is good, right? Now this happens. Whereas with the other line, you'd go use face into this, he drops Pit Fighter, you double trade if you want to, you ignore it if you want to, but it becomes awkward.
Shield Bearer Shadow Pan, clear Zubat with face, push 3-2.
Shield Bearer Shadow Pan, face into his guy, 3 face, yep. Ooh, Shield Bearer in the middle, right? Kind of cold. You draw the Raven Freeze that?
Yeah, kind of cold.
And Betrayal and Explosive and whatever. For most things, Shield Bearer should be in the middle.
I can hear chat now.
Like, no, wrong spot.
I'm only good at winning the lottery.
Well, you don't really force him to ping, but you make it awkward if he doesn't ping, Koi. I think that's what he was trying to say. Because he can do whatever, right? He can fireball himself in the play, in the face. Like, you don't have anything to say about that.
Taunt the 3-2? 2-5. I mean, explain. I guess it's technically the same if we do Pompous.
How about we play Silent Knight, Taunt the Panda, go face, dagger his face. Silent Knight should be in the middle.
Yeah.
So, obviously this is not, like, I don't think you usually play this fast, right? This is just because I'm saying what to do, right? And you're going more into execute mode. So, the play that you suggested, right? Was that to play around Flamestrike somehow, or? You all right? I think he needs a second, guys. Fight count, man. Do-do-do-do-do.
All right, sorry.
We good? All right, let's put the swashbuckler down, right? We don't have that much time anymore, so I'm just gonna execute. We'll talk about it after. That is very useless here. 3-2 into the 3-3. Play the thespian on the far right, and then go face with everything, redagger. Kinda got raided. Yeah. Only sounds that way, guys. This guy's packing portals.
Imager.com/a/
cracking the 5-6, put the 2-2 into the 5-6. Or do we crack in his face and set up for a burst down turn? What do we have? No, we don't.
I think Kraken is due to trade the shield. Two face is fine. Yeah. Anonymous, is this the most OP arena draft ever? I usually don't open links, my friend.
A daggering face, right?
Yeah.
Imager.com/a/ctq7bis. This the most upper arena draft ever.
I think this might be a repeat donation. All right, let's go in here. Thanks so much for the $6, Anonymous. Hello. Stop doing things. This guy and his things, man. This guy and his things. At first? It's pretty funny. Oh, come on, Dick.
So we clear. I think we play crowd favorite.
Crowd favorite for sure. Let's put him on the far right. So now you have options, right? You can use a 2-2, keep everything alive. You can use a 1-1 in your face, or you can use Arcane Explosion in your face.
I think I'd Arcane Explosion and use my face to preserve the two bodies. And then push, you know, we get three to the face.
I don't think it matters enough. I think I'd use the 1-1 in the face and then put two to the face. Like, he's not dead one turn earlier. You don't kill him next turn by doing this. I don't think Arcane Explosion is going to be very useful either, but I think it's going to be more useful than dealing one face, because that's kind of what it does here. Because at this point, the mana to ping is not worth it.
Feels hey, good. We won the coin flip.
Feels good, man. Arcane Explosion is doing things.
Sap the Shredder, Arcane Explosion. Yep. And face the 4-2 and play the Toad?
Yep, you got it. Die, mage, die!
And redagger for the lulz.
Sure. I think usually in this particular case I'd redagger first and then stab just because of Harrison, but I don't think it matters enough. Alright. You know the place, Froggy. Come on, baby. Come on. Right here. Oh, terrible. Alright. Easiest fireball of our lives. Yep. Oh, we have lethal anyway. Alright. Kill him. Alright. I forgot we had a thing. Alright. GG, guys.
Hey, we're at 10.
Yep. Yeah, Rogue is still a good class, right?
Alright.
Sorry, you were about to ask something or say something.
We're a little over. I gotta take down a music sheet for my daughter practicing the clarinet. I'll be like 60 seconds.
You can queue up already then. And then
okay.
For 60 seconds. Yeah. We had lethal before Shady saw it. Feels good, man. I hope he's back in time. Maybe 60 seconds. Yeah, 60 seconds probably a little close. Ah, good luck. We have a premium hand here. Kappa Kippo. Have you ever missed lethal since you've become an experienced player? Yes. Probably yesterday. I mean, it happens. It doesn't happen super frequently, but it happens for sure. Especially depending on what I'm doing, right? I think I've missed lethal on purpose 2 days ago or 3 days ago, where we played an Onyxia over killing him because it was too much fun. Why queue up? Because I don't really want another break.
Keep the sap, toss the rest.
It's a mage, so I wouldn't keep sap. No, I would just throw it all. Like, we'd rather find one of our early game minions or a backstab or such. Yeah, that works. Check. Mayhem's back? Yeah. That famous guy.
Let me see. Huge toad?
Yeah. If he had played a balanced minion, I would have daggered, but he played an OP minion, so we can't dagger. He played a chugger, guys. He did it. This guy. This guy and his chuggers.
Well, it's kind of an awkward fan, right? I mean, we have to get rid of the chugger.
Well, you don't have to. So I'll let you in on my decision-making here, right? I'm pretty sure we're playing Swashbuckler, because even if you want to get rid of the chugger, you can then use your Valiant to ping the 1-1 and trade into the chugger, but you may also free kill the 1-1 and ping the frog. But we'll do the Swashbuckler and get more information.
Okay. So... you think we should burglar, see what we get, and then Valiant ping this, and then clear the chugger?
We'll play the swash burglar, we'll see what we get.
I like that.
I think it may be okay to just ping the 2-1 and then free kill the 1-1. I think that's fine. Okay. Once again, normally you'd want the 1-1 in the middle, but it shouldn't matter now. You don't even have mana to Conan. Like, it's not going to matter enough.
So we'd put the 1-1 here. Why exactly? Like, if it's cone, right, it wouldn't.
Usually you want your 1-1 in the middle to say next turn we play a Yeti, right? Then you can put your Yeti on an edge and then your 1-1 is towards the center. Whereas now your 1-1 is not, so it's easier for him to avoid stuff. Ugh. Well, that sucks.
So, yeah. I guess we clear the Chugga since he's annoying.
Well, because we don't have anything to do, I kind of want to mess with his mind here. I think we just dagger up and poison and then wait a little bit, give him the thought that we meant to poison this turn, so... because we're just spending our mana here because we don't have anything else to do. So now we just wait a little bit. Maybe point at our face, at his chugger and stuff. Let him be a little bit confused. If I'm going to do it anyway, I like to mess with my opponent. Maybe drop their guard a little bit. Think that he's playing against the noob. All right, yeah, we trade off the Valiant and then push full phase. Can you explain why you pinged the 2-1 and not the 1-1 killing the chugger? Because it made him hero power on his turn. It made him hero power on his turn 3. Whereas if he hadn't, we'd still have that frog. So you kind of make him hero power on an awkward turn. Normally it's really good. It's just unfortunate that we didn't have anything to go with it. It would have been really nice if we had a shredder on 4, and our play would have definitely paid off. Ugh, we need a backstab.
Yeah. I mean, I get we can five drop. I guess the 3-7's not too bad. I mean,
Shadow
he trades
Ban for sure. Yeah, I think we're just talking about whether this 2-1 is getting killed by our weapon or not, right?
Yeah.
So, let's talk. Next turn is face a summoner turn, almost guaranteed, which means no fan.
Yep.
Our opponent plays his generic 5. We have a 3-7 rather than a 3-5. Yeah, I think you kill it with your face. I don't like it very much, but I think you do. So my logic for this one is that you definitely don't want your guy going to 5 because of Firelands Portal, right? I know it's 2 turns down the line. But the main reason is that most 5 drops can't really deal that well with a 3-7. Whereas if you let it take 2 damage next turn, you'll not only put it in fireball range or flame cannon ping range or whatever, it also just, you know, it does a lot less work versus what he's about to play. Tempo assassinate. Yeah, guys, that would have been great last turn, right?
Yeah, I still think we're doing the faceless.
Yep, faces on the left, please. Puts the weaker guy in the middle.
And then the 3-7 clears the 2-2. Or we're kind of at that same point where you drop to 5 health.
So if this goes,
or we clear the 2-2 with our face. And
yeah,
push the three.
I think I'm pretty happy just using our face and then pushing the 3. I think that's fine. Keeping our guy healthy. He will portal the summoner. Does he still have a coin? He may have.
No, he doesn't have a coin.
All right, so he can't portal the summoner then. Sorry, we have our sprint as well, which makes me a little bit happier in a mage matchup, because it could go very long. Guess he would have liked to hit the 5-5 instead. No, just trades. Yeah, go face, please. Oh, wow. So he could be trying to mind game us back, then make him think he's got flame strike.
Clear his guy and sprint. Get some cards.
Then he plays portal and we probably never recover.
No.
What's a decent alternative to that?
We can assassinate the Thespian and drop a micro machine.
Is that a decent alternative to that, right?
Fan dagger.
Yeah, fan dagger. Looks fine, right? Let's draw a card first. Use a fan. Alright, yep. Just dagger his dudes. Play the micro. 3 face.
I mean, if we were going to talk about tempo assassinating a 2-1 loot hoarder, I mean,
this is nothing then, right? Yeah. Go for a run. Yeah, let's go for a run, guys. This is why you don't like sprint. Why? Because it's always there for you, even if you're running out of cards. Why would you? Oh, wow. We need 1 sap, please. Nope. Okay. Feels bad, man. So if we spread here and he flame strikes, the game is over. I think that means we sprint.
Is that what we're doing? We're sprinting?
That's what we're doing. Yeah, I'm making the executive call here because I don't want to put you through the agony of going through this turn. Because it's normally very bad here to sprint, but I don't want to lose to a... Ooh, that's good.
We got the sap. We shield bearer sap?
Well, that'd be 3 mana, right? But we like Shield Bearer here in the
middle.
Oh,
yeah, Shield Bearer and then Sap next turn.
Oh, yeah, Shield Bearer in the middle. Yep. And then face with our dudes, keep the face. So, this is something that I've learned to do, is just sprint a bit earlier. And now suddenly the roles are flipped, right? Because the mage is the one that used to sit back and be like, ah, it's fine. I've got more cards. He needs to deal with my guy. He needs to be, you know, he needs to speed up. Whereas now, we just.
We just sprinted, so he's now the aggressor. He needs to play fast.
No. So I think we're sapping Karn, no matter what. Right?
Yeah, we're sapping the Karn. That's definitely happening.
We can Shredder.
I don't really like what the 7-4 does to our 3-7 here.
Yeah.
I also don't really want to play into Flamestrike again, so I think I'm pretty happy just assassinating his dude here. And then we're pushing 3 phase for sure. So next turn we'd have 6, 8, 4, 4, 3. We can play Thespian, it's fine. We don't need to discount. It's cool. I'd use face, I think. Yeah, face is fine. Cool. So yeah, these particular turns, they've become a lot more difficult now. So it's slightly less coaching and a little bit more talking through what we want to do at the same time.
Yeah.
So the main goal right now is to make it so his Karn can't get enough value.
I think we're shadow striking the animated armor.
I do think that's what we're doing, which means we'd have 6, 8, 9, which means we'd be 3 off. I do agree with the shadow strike on the animated armor. We'll get that out of the way.
SI7 the 2-2.
Sure.
This guy's toast. And then I think Shredder for a sticky minion in case he top decks a Flamestrike.
We actually don't know if he has Flamestrike. We haven't given him a good Flamestrike board. So I think we're
Fork?
No, I think that we go. We haven't used our face yet, right? Yeah, so we play Summoner Dagger this turn. And we just throw Thespian and face into his dude and push 3 with the panda. Like, this still makes it awkward. And then next turn we can just go all in into a Flamestrike because we'll have too much damage anyway. Like, Flamestrike won't help him. The only play why this could be bad is that now you potentially put him in a position where he can kill you. But I mean, you have lethal on the board, so first of all, he needs to react to what you have, which he did. That's one off. Huh.
Bump the 2-2 into the 1-2, backstab the 1-2.
We almost had a very sexy lethal by backstabbing our own fork, but it doesn't work. This is 5.
Two, two into the 1-2.
Yeah, 2-2 into the 1-2. Backstab the 1-2. Play the Shredder in the fork. Push everything face. Including your face. I guess you're fine dropping Crowd's favorite as well, because AoE won't cut it. So, I think we would have been totally fine with tanking the 1 and then killing him. Oh, did he draw lethal? Gotta be kidding me. No, okay, GG. Good stuff. Yeah, we took a little bit of a risk here. We could have totally removed the 3-4. Alright, GG. Flamestrike doesn't do anything near Danny. Alright. Why do we miss one damage on our pint size to save one health? Because we're scared of dying in that particular case. But I think that it would have been better. Like I said, it's more of a. It's been a very long run. I think that
Is it Diggy Diggy time?
It is Diggy Diggy time, so just hold on for 1 sec. I think that the right play on that particular board state was face and the. Three. I guess maybe face and a 3 into the 1-2, backstab and 2 into the 3-4, then play out and go face, and you still have lethal most of the time. On the other hand, you do want to make him dead to fork, so it's pretty tricky, that one. Alright, anyways, let's get digging. Let's do it, man. Either way, we've had a good value for the session.
Yeah.
A lot of time. Alright, good to go.
Diggy diggy time.
Diggy diggy time, boys. We had a fork, by the way, Physics Squirrel. So. You're killing him regardless if he AoEs.
Oh, this is gonna be interesting. 11 and 2 warrior. It's one of those mythical unicorn warriors.
Warrior. Yeah, he's gonna be packing a lot of good stuff. What do you want to keep here?
Keep a swashburglar?
I'm pretty sure we keep both burglars as a minimum. I think I like everything but the pint size too. That's fine.
Pompous kind of eats a charge off his axe, so he's not hitting us in the face with it.
Yeah, and I mean, he's not guaranteed to have one. Right? That's fine. I think most likely thing is he plays Nazoths. Right? Ooh. So, he's been playing roulette. Nice. Alright guys, remember, if you're having fun and you are new to the stream, guys, make sure to hit the follow button, that's very much appreciated. Play the burglar here. Currently finishing up a coaching session, we're fine holding, we don't need the combo. We want to go slow, right? This guy probably has quite some reactive stuff. Ooh.
Ooh, that turn 2 armor up.
So he's going pretty slow as well. Dig.
Thespian? Or Dag? Yeah. Well, I guess we'll be fine. Yeah, Thespian or I guess
fine. We don't want to go too slow if he's going really slow, right? Oh baby, I love him already. Oh
nope.
Bam. I love Ogre Varmo, man. I love ogres in general. Ogres are good.
Swashburglar. Well, we could coin Shredder, but then he one shots it if his charge procs.
Which we wouldn't mind.
No, he takes 4 to the face, and we end up with another minion.
Yeah, coin Shredder, and then face for 3. So the reason why I do this is that next turn we can then swashburglar a Psy if we need to, or just play a 2-drop and a dagger, or just swashburglar and a dagger. Lots of options this way. It's probably gonna have those things.
Oh, that's a thing.
Please.
Backstab SI.
Too fast. We don't need to stab. We can play the swashburglar here. We can trade an
arse. And then trade the scarab. Yeah. Trade the scarab.
Especially against warriors, which, you know, have things like ghoul. Yep. And you still have your backstab for your shadow pan, perhaps.
We got the warbot, man.
The value. I think we're fine on value. We have our sprint. Hey, there's the pit fighter himself.
Backstab, Undercity. Just a 3, puts him in 2. Backstab, Undercity. And then dagger it and trade the 1/1.
So
yeah, we can do a lot of things.
He's playing really slow, right?
He's going
the value route. So what I like here is to just trade in the Swashbuckler to play around MCT and play Psychotron and hit him in the face. And then next turn we can still use Dagger Valiance to deal the 2 after he kills the Pompous. Yeah. So this plays around both Ghoul and Mstitek. Because I don't know, there was something about the way how he put that prince down that I feel like he has MCT. I don't know why. I know I'm paranoid about MCT a lot of the times. Wait, what? You hit the shield? Or we're hitting the 3?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you feeling the tech? Are you feeling the tech with me here?
Yeah.
My MCT senses are tingling, man.
He wants us to play stuff.
I almost want to play into it because I want to find out whether I'm right, but that's probably wrong. All right, let's think about it. Yeah, I think we just probably play into it. I don't think we have a good way around it.
Okay.
We play Micro Machine. We Undercity Valiant is 5/2.
Dagger, be clear, right?
That's the 2/5, right? That's not the 5/2.
Shit.
That is not the 5/2. All right. Oh, now MCT is gonna matter. That's fine. All right, dagger up.
I did a thing.
It's okay. Use the psycho in the face into his guy, and there's 2/4. Now you have to go full face now, I think. So, yeah. It's okay. So, I don't know, man. Am I good at this game? Is he playing MCT? I don't know. The way how we played the Malcazar on 5 and was happy with it. I could be very wrong about it, of course, because it's a rare. It's not very likely he has it, but there's something about it, man. There's something about it. We take less phase damage now? Yeah, it's okay. He does kill one of our guys, right? He does kill one of our guys. Do you have a Geddon? Please don't. Alright. Not MC tech. Alrighty. Execute. Okie dokie. Alright, so then I think it's just wrong what he did. If you don't have an MCT, I think that's wrong.
I think we fan. I mean, we can.
Yeah, we backstab the 3/3 first, and then we fan. All right, trade off the Valiant.
Valiant into that.
Yep. Face with our dudes, and then we can talk about what we want to play here.
So we can stab face, re-dagger, and then play a sparring partner, or we can go all out and go Warbot Silent Night and threaten.
I like Warbot, taunt the Warbot, and then punch one face. That plays around things like Argent Commander and such. Just keep the stab face. This keeps your Micro Machine healthy, right? Sure.
The draws.
Oh my god.
We win.
Yeah, make sure you finish him with the Great Staff.
With the Great Staff?
Oh yeah.
It has to be the Great Staff.
Oh yeah. So 3/3 into his dudes, and then face. And I hit him with the shtick. No!
No!
GG!
Rogue is still a pretty rewarding class.
That's nice. My first 12 win ever, by the way. Thank you.
Oh, cherry popped. Feels good, man. All right. Let me get your screen back on here. Let's see what's in there. Alrighty, man. You can open up. Was a little bit of a eventful run, a little bit of an obstacle here and there, but we got there in the end.
Okay. And the game where we DC'd and they conceded.
Yeah. pretty well, I mean, we had one there, right? Yeah, you can open up. It's good. You can see it.
There we go, guys. You want the pack too?
Oh yeah, we want it all. That's a good amount of money.
Boo, pack.
So, do you have any more questions regarding the coaching session? Anything?
That's a lot to take in. Like, mm-hmm. I'll grab the VOD and kind of go back through. I also have the replay from the deck tracker that I can also add.
Yeah, I think that, especially this is why I usually just recommend it, that people come on the stream, because it's so handy that you just have the replay. You can just go over everything. So a couple things from my end that I can just give away is the mulligans. Pay close attention to the mulligans. I always let you tell me what you wanted to do first, so listen about what you are about to do, and then listen to what I was going to do and how that is different, what I'm focusing on. Don't overvalue your removal, as in the Hunter game where you wanted to dagger rather than use the SI. Also don't, and this is obviously a little bit contradictory, but don't overreact to what your opponent's playing, like with the Flame Waker, the Shadow Strike there. That was also a point where it was good to just let him come out. And then I think one other game with a Kraken, that was a pretty big one where you wanted to react to what he had rather than develop the Kraken. Like, yeah, it was a slightly messier clear with using Kraken on his 4-4 and then trade the other guys. But with the other line, you're not putting down a 9-7. So whenever you're looking at a clear for your opponent's board, always think about, what am I giving up for this? What am I not developing if I'm clearing here? That's a pretty big question.
Yep.
Alrighty. Well, I had a good time, man.
Yeah, appreciate it.
Take care, Red Panda.
Yep, hopefully we'll see you on another stream.
Yeah, for sure, man. Just throw up whenever. All right, see you, bro.
Yep, bye.
That was good stuff, guys. That was good stuff.